Harry posted a tweet and it got deleted.
I think it was.
Can you scoot this over, please, sir?
I think it was a couple of weeks ago. Why didn't we do this
earlier?
Night. Why wasn't this done earlier during the production setup?
Why wasn't what done earlier?
This
because we didn't do a camera test.
Oh,
we had bigger things
to
fix.
Now it looks over to the.
I don't care.
Or this side.
Yeah, I don't care.
Yeah.
Well, at least it covers up your gut, and you know my gut's on full exposure here, and you can fucking hide your face a little bit.
Anyway, we forgot the t-shirts tonight.
I didn't forget it. It was too fucking cold. I'm not wearing a t-shirt when it's that cold in here.
It is. Can you tell these guys?
It's they could probably hear it. I would assume
they may be able to hear it now that we have the music turned down. But it is.
It stopped for now. But listen, when the wind blows, it goes.
Right.
It's sleeting outside very badly.
It's a hell of an ice storm. We had snow earlier. It was snowing pretty good out. Picked up a couple of inches, an inch or two, something like that, and then it changed over to sleet and freezing rain. And right now it's sleet, but they're saying freezing rain later, and it's going to be a mess. We've had what? I would say 2 to 3 feet of snow on the ground for the past
weeks. Yeah.
At least a month.
At least a month.
It's
a fucking mess outside.
It seems like every couple of days we get snow up here. You know what I mean? Where it's just nonstop.
Maybe not a big storm, but enough that it stays consistent and there's fucking always snow on the ground.
Right.
And the roads are always shit.
And it's been freezing cold. They said it was the third coldest February on record going back.
Oh, we're in March now.
We're in March now,
yeah.
But for February...
Listen.
It's crazy, right?
It's pretty loud,
It's coming down.
I don't know if that's loud enough to come on the mic there, but it's loud. You can take your word for it.
So, here's the deal. First of all, everybody is talking about a big trade in the NFL today, right?
And
I haven't put anything up on Facebook about it yet.
You can't wait.
But we are
bad enough I got to be big, fat, fucking hairy guy on the camera here.
We are white.
No, I'm incredible. I'm not this white in reverse.
I just say that ice is very annoying.
Yeah, it's
very. It's almost worse than Jacob crying.
I wouldn't put it that far, but it is distracting.
It's pretty bad, man. It's just.
Well, if you're not a weatherman,
pounding on the window,
ignore it. Like me, I don't give a shit what it's doing out there because I'm.
Oh, I'm so used to Jacob crying that I tell you every week. You got to put that out of your mind. You got
to. I've been living here for 2 years, bro. I'm used to him crying too. It still gets on my motherfucking nerves when it's bad.
He's a kid. Yeah. He's a kid. Anyway, so everybody's talking about this big trade in the NFL today, right? Where. I don't even know if it was a trade. I haven't read anything. I've just seen what you guys have put up on my Facebook page. But the Philadelphia Eagles...
what did they put up on your Facebook page? A GoFundMe campaign? Or
we're going to talk about that here in a minute.
I know.
We'll talk about that in a minute. But we're going to get this stuff out of the way.
I know.
And we'll move on and do the regular show. But
you gave me a perfect opportunity for a joke. I took it.
We got LeSean McCoy from...
Not we,
the Eagles.
You.
Yeah, the Bills. Yeah. The Bills.
Detroit Lions didn't get no LeSean McCoy.
LeSean McCoy.
If we had a LeSean McCoy to go with a Calvin Johnson and a Matthew Stafford, we'd be unfucking stoppable.
I mean, listen, I'm going to have to go back and, like I said, all I've seen is what you guys have put up on my Facebook page, but I'm going to have to go back and read what the deal is or what the trade was, because I have no idea. But LeSean McCoy to the Buffalo Bills, I mean, LeSean McCoy is a beast.
He's
of a running back.
Monster.
But... We've already got...
Here's where he doesn't know football. Watch, listen to this, guys. I was just talking to him off the air.
We've already got Fred Jackson, who's our starting running back, and...
Fred Jackson, LeSean McCoy... All
right, I'm...
what the fuck are we talking about?
And
here?
We've got C.J. Spiller as well. Why are you underestimating C.J. Spiller and Fred Jackson? You're acting like they're not good running
backs. I'm not acting like they're not good running backs, but they're not LeSean McCoy...
LeSean McCoy's better than both of them as
combined.
Far as stats and numbers.
Yeah.
Dude, C.J. Spiller and Fred Jackson are pretty fucking
They're
nasty.
Very good.
They're pretty fucking nasty.
But as I put it off air before we came on the air just now, LeSean McCoy is a game changer. He's going to take the Bills into a different level.
Right, but wait a
minute.
They
could build an offense around that fucking guy.
But we had a fairly decent season this past year, okay?
Yeah.
And
you guys are on the way up with LeSean McCoy.
Our defense was excellent, okay? Our defense was excellent.
Exactly.
Our offense was pretty freaking good. Our running backs were great. They were
great.
Yes.
Good.
Dude, they were very good this year.
Good.
What is our main problem?
You need a receiver.
We need a quarterback.
And a quarterback.
We need a quarterback,
right? We don't
really
have any receivers either.
So, why are we getting LeSean McCoy?
Because they're
going to
be a ground offense, and you got the killer defense, like you just said, which I agree
with. I get it.
That right there is a game changer. Why? Because now they can mix it up so much that, that the opposing team will not know if it's going in the air, it's going on the ground. Because obviously you're going on the ground a lot because you got McCoy, but when are you going on the ground? They don't know. You figure it out, all right, probably on first down, or second and third down, they'll probably go on the ground. But you switch it up, you throw a curve ball, you throw a left one, you're expecting a right.
I'm not, it may sound like I'm complaining that we got LeSean McCoy.
It does.
I love.
It shocks me.
I love the fact that we got LeSean McCoy to the Bills. I fucking love it, dude. Come on, dude. He's one of the best running backs.
I love Reggie Bush. I love Joique Bell.
Right.
If the Lions picked up LeSean McCoy, I would say,
absolutely.
Hey, Reggie Bush and Joique Bell are great players because I'm a fucking home team fan. I just support my Lions. But I would be fucking jumping up and down if we got LeSean McCoy.
We got LeSean McCoy. I love it. Dude, it's awesome, bro. He's one of the best running backs in the league.
Read
right?
Stephen Grabake's comment on the air right now.
Oh, God, Clark, you don't know football.
Thank you.
Game changer, Grabake.
Is it not a game changer?
It is a game changer.
All right, so why are you down in the dumps about getting McCoy?
LeSean McCoy is great. I'm fucking thrilled to have him on the Bills. Problem is, our problem isn't the running backs, bro. Our problem is not that. This past year.
Actually, you know what? There's some comments very much supporting you now.
CJ and Freddie.
Sorry, real quick to get it out of the system, they were complaining that we don't interact with them enough. In the chat room on the air.
All right, well, interact.
So I'm going to try and throw some shit in every once in a while tonight.
But it's awesome that we have LeSean McCoy, but that wasn't our problem. Our running game wasn't the problem this past year, the year before that, the year before that.
Yeah.
Our problem is the quarterback. But granted, we got LeSean McCoy. That's awesome. Now, I'm guessing, now that we probably paid a lot of money to get LeSean McCoy, C.J. Spiller or Freddie Jackson is out, and we're going to get rid of them because we don't
what
need...
What did you get rid of
we
to
don't
get
need,
McCoy?
I don't know. That's what I need to read up on. I have no idea what the
somebody
trade was.
Somebody in the chat, tell us. Who did they get rid of to get McCoy?
But we're going to get rid of one of those guys. I mean, we don't need... Listen, we
even
don't
if
need...
don't get rid of them, they're going to be sitting on
we
the
don't
bench
need,
a lot.
We don't need LeSean McCoy, Fred Jackson, and C.J. Spiller as three running backs. Even if they were to split, you know, even carries. And LeSean's going to be the main back, obviously, man. He's better than both of them. But that wasn't our problem. Why aren't we taking this money, or whatever the trade was, whether we spent money, why aren't we taking this and getting a good quarterback? That's what we
Kiko
need.
Kiko Alonso, do you know who that is?
I've heard of him.
So that's
I've
who you got rid of to get McCoy, I guess. That's what they're
all right, but we need a quarterback. We don't need a running back. Our running back wasn't the problem.
Linebacker.
So
okay.
Spend money. Go.
Wow. You guys traded Kiko Alonso for McCoy.
I'm
I thought
sure,
there were like three or four names.
I'm sure there was a first-round draft pick or a second-round draft, some sort of draft
let
pick.
Let me ask you this question. Your defense was gangster this past
awesome.
Year.
Awesome.
Was Kiko a big part of it? Are you sacrificing your defense to get McCoy? Because then I would think it's a dumb move.
I mean...
Because your running was good enough, like you said, if you're going to fuck your defense up, which was like a major part of
the
your guys.
The fact that you just asked me who Kiko Alonso was, and
that's
I said, I've heard of him.
Yeah.
I've heard of him. And he's
a lot of people don't know defensive players unless they're like really
right.
big names like Ray Lewis or...
I don't think it's... I think that's a pretty fucking good trade. If it was Kiko Alonso from LeSean McCoy, that's pretty fucking good.
Unless he was a crucial...
I'm sure there
was linebacker
else.
Is an important position, so...
I'm
and you're
sure.
Your guys' defense won you a lot of games, so if you're sacrificing your defense to get this big, shiny name...
All right.
I don't think that's a good move.
I'm sure that there's more to it, whether it be money or draft picks.
Oh, they say
like
one for one,
one
for one.
All right.
Straight up
right.
trade.
Then that's...
So he must be great.
That's awesome, then.
If the
that's
team...
Awesome.
Who was McCoy playing for? Not Seattle.
Philadelphia.
Philadelphia. So if Philadelphia was willing to trade one for one like that, then Kiko must be a game-changer linebacker.
But they're saying he was injured all year, and maybe that's why I haven't heard much about him.
No, they said he tore his knee up his rookie year.
Oh, well.
Oh, no, Kiko was hurt all year. You're right, I'm sorry.
Hurt all year. Okay. So anyway, so that's a big pickup for the Bills. Absolutely.
It's going to make you a bigger franchise because you're going to sell more jerseys, more tickets, because you got a guy that people know like
right.
the back of their hand. He's a big fucking name, LeSean McCoy.
Right. Right. But we need to work on our quarterback, and I know they want to put a lot of stock in E.J.
Oh,
Manuel.
You guys lost Spiller. Here you go. This just came out 20 minutes
ago. All right,
ago.
There you go.
Impending free agent running back C.J. Spiller said Tuesday that he will not return to the Bills, who reportedly have a deal in place to acquire Eagles running back LeSean McCoy.
There you
go. NFL Network reports, I won't be returning to Buffalo, Spiller said. Thank you, Chris Brown.
But she knew that was coming. They don't need C.J. Spiller.
No, not
Fred Jackson.
One or the other.
LeSean McCoy.
Yeah.
Right, and Freddie Jackson's going to turn into a backup.
Why do
which
I just picture Freddie
with.
Jackson as a Jaguars wide receiver? Who did they have? Somebody named Jackson or Fred.
Vincent
or
Jackson?
Maybe that's it.
There's Vincent Jackson. Who's
Fred
that
Jackson.
Thing?
I just pictured a Jaguar right. helmet on.
No, all right. So Spiller's gone, but that's a big loss, man. C.J. Spiller, but LeSean McCoy.
You had him
is,
in fantasy, right?
I did. Yeah. I did this
Spiller,
past year.
2 years?
And the year before.
Yeah.
And the year before that. But so it's awesome to have LeSean McCoy, but our main, listen, let's spend some money on a quarterback. I get it.
Sorry, Chris Brown says, no problem, boom, but both Spiller and Fred Jackson are free agents.
So Freddie Jackson may be out, too.
So you don't have a backup, so you better hope McCoy don't get hurt. Is he injury prone? Like Stafford?
I think McCoy was injured within the last couple of years. I think.
Bam!
I believe so.
Winner's lair. Fred Jackson was older player for the Jaguars.
He was older.
A wide receiver.
And Fred Jackson is an older guy.
No. He's talking about a different guy named Fred Jackson. He's a wide receiver, he says. Right, so, yeah. Right. I knew there was a... I lived in Jacksonville for fucking 10 years.
So, it's a big pickup for the Bills, but I think we need to spend money, go out and invest in a quarterback. Somebody that's a
backup.
Who do
you got? EJ Manuel?
EJ Manuel, and we've got...
I think he's a good quarterback.
We had... what's his name? Kyle Orton,
But EJ Emanuel, I think, is a guy that if you give him a couple years, he's going to be a beast. Kind of like Stafford with the Lions. Stafford had glimpses of potential every once in a while.
Right.
A, he would get hurt all the time, and B, he wasn't really used to the transition from the college to the pros.
But
once he got the hang of it, though, this past year, Stafford was a fucking monster. But I think EJ Emanuel in about 2 years from now, he's going to be a monster,
but
too.
But in the NFL, you say, you know, give him a couple of years. In the NFL, you don't have a couple of years. It's like your first,
Emmanuel's
second
a new guy.
Season. Right, he's a new guy, but they benched him halfway through the season.
Because he's not the guy yet.
They benched
him.
And
they had a good backup.
Kyle Orton.
Yeah.
Right, not a good backup. I mean, Kyle Orton.
You were trending the other day. Ryan Clark was on Facebook trending
from
who
the guy
it? The kicker?
The Steelers.
The kicker?
No, he's a... Defensive
tackle or
lineman or somebody like all that right. From the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
I seen it. He was churning. I said, look at that.
All right.
Churning.
So here's the deal. Listen.
You want to do your speech now?
I'm going to do my speech, and I asked you to be a little bit serious.
No, I'll respect
here,
this.
And,
this is a big fucking thing. I know.
It's a big deal for you and I both. As
it affects me, too. Yeah.
We live together.
I got a raise this past week, Bob.
You did.
For
you
guys
did.
Listening.
$100, man. Which is pretty fucking good, man.
My raise was okay. Your money thing's fucked. My sister's shit's fucked up, though, so I got some sadness in my life, too.
Right.
But
right.
Nothing like this, because this is like, this is a game changer in a bad way. But we're gonna get
through. Before everything, we get through everything.
Do your speech.
So
goddamn right we do.
Here's the deal. I'll start
real
back.
Quick before you get started. Dino UK was giving us some tips in the chat just now. I want to say, A, I didn't know about his health issues.
I think it's okay that we say it on here.
He posted it on a public thing, so.
Dino UK has cancer, and we did not know that. I didn't know that.
He's got the BWR radio show, right?
When we started
at Battle Royal in England.
We started a fantasy football league last year, and the problem was that I started that league 2 or 3 days
before the
season was to begin, so I wasn't able to set up the point system and everything else.
Yeah.
And we did it very quickly, and I got 8 or 10 guys, whatever it was, and I got an email or a PM or something from Dino in the chat room that says, "Hey, I'm hospitalized," and
you beat it.
Yes, he.
Man! I was about to say good luck with everything.
But I put up a thing, and I needed 8-10 guys real quick.
Well, they all know about it, so obviously.
Didn't know that half of them were you know, I didn't know if they listened to the radio show or whatnot.
Yeah.
I just needed 8-10 guys. A ticket. I got a PM from Dean, and he said, "Listen, I'm hospitalized, and I'm not going to be able to do the league. So if you can find somebody else, it's not a problem." Took him out of the league, and I would have loved to have him in the league, but I had to go and find somebody else. Dino said to me that he wasn't able to be in the league, so I found somebody else. No idea. I don't even remember who it was, but put him in the league, and turns out that, you know, I get all these messages the other day that, you know, I made fun of a cancer patient, this, that, and the other thing.
Where the hell did that come from?
You guys that have watched this show, we've been here for 10-plus years, know that I'm not that kind of guy. I would never do something like that.
I wouldn't sit here and let him either. I've lost a father figure to cancer. My sister battles cancer. My mother battles. I would not do that. I would not sit here and joke about cancer.
Not something that I would do. So when I found out the other day, I had said to Dean, listen, man, hopefully. And he said that he had beat it.
That's fucking awesome.
Which is awesome, man.
Which,
fucking great.
Fingers crossed it doesn't come back because there's a good.
My stepmother has cancer.
Did she beat it
my
and it came back?
No, she's in like stage. Four. I don't know what the stages are, but she's up there. That's a good.
What kind of cancer? Do you know?
My father is always putting stuff up on Facebook.
Cervical?
She had to go, and it was like $7,000 or $8,000 for wigs. She got two different wigs. They had to shave her
my
head.
My grandma didn't do that.
Yeah. Everything else, man, it was crazy. But, all right, so I'll go back a couple of months ago. I use, basically, when you guys visit WZRonline.com, ProWrestlingScoops.com, wherever you go, whether you come from EWN, whatever, you guys see the content on the websites, and then at the top of the website, you'll see kind of like a, they call it a leaderboard. And on the side of the websites, they call it skyscrapers. They're advertisements that run on the website. And basically, that stuff works,
box
ups,
ads, video
and pop-ups, and everything else, the way that stuff works is some of it's on a CPC basis, some of it's on a CPM basis.
Real quick, CPC means you got to click to get paid. CPM means you get paid every time it shows up.
CPM is per every 1,000 hits. You get a percentage of what they pay you, and
you don't gotta click.
Back in the days of UGO and
CPA means you have to sign up.
Right. CPC, but
no, CPC is click. CPA
is
sign up.
You have to sign up, right? But back in the days of UGO and IGN and all
those
these other
were the
companies,
days,
I mean,
man.
They would pay you per every 1,000 hits you would get. You would make $2, $3, $4, sometimes even
$5 CPM
per every 1,000. We're not talking uniques. We're talking page views. We're talking page views.
Yeah.
So a unique visitor is a different person,
yes.
Like you or I, and then that unique visitor clicks, you know, 5, 6,
you go to
seven
TMZ
times.
Every day, but you're only one unique for them. If
right.
you visit 20 posts, you're 20 page views for them.
You're 20 page views.
Yeah.
So back in the day of the IGN and the UGOs and these other companies, even Burst Media back in the day,
Burst was
good. They would pay you $2 or $3.
Tribal
these
Fusion
days,
was good at one.
These days, the problem with pro wrestling websites is wrestling fans don't click. You guys come to the websites, you want
especially
the content.
Especially wrestling. Oh, you already said that. Okay.
You want the news, you want the rumors, you read the post, and you could give two fucks about a Coca-Cola
or
ad,
a credit card,
or a Pepsi
yeah.
ad, or a college ad that
yeah.
you see on the top. You guys aren't clicking those
no.
ads. You want to read the news, you want the rumors, and then you bounce out, and you go to your next website. That's the way it works. So basically, the way that I make money is I do that same thing. I run advertisements on the website. You guys see the leaderboards. You guys see the skyscrapers and the box ads. You know, and these days, I mean, back in the day, it would pay $2, $3, $4. Now we're down to around 20 cents, 25 cents,
and that's
30
good.
Cents.
20, 30.
That's
cents.
Good.
Yeah.
If you're getting 25, 30 cents. Per every 1,000 hits, that's why I see a lot of people, they want to open a website, how can I make money off this, how can I do this? You got to have the traffic, and one good thing about what I've been doing this for 15 years now, 16 yeah. years now, is I've been able to build a solid fan base with ProWrestlingScoops.com and WZROnline.com, where I do have the traffic, and basically WZRonline.com averages about 100,000 page views per day. Pro Wrestling Scoops, 200,000 to 250,000 page views a day. So, despite the fact that I'm being paid...
How many page views
a day? 200,000 to 250,000, you know. So basically, you know, that 20, 25, 30 cent CPM, I'm able to make money. So, I ran a company called YardBarker.com. Yard Barker, an advertising company that was, if you've gone to Yard Barker, you know about Yard Barker.
They're a big-ass company.
They are a company that runs sports ads, whether it be the NFL, whether it be NHL, NBA, WWE, MMA. And a couple of months ago, I got an email, two different emails, actually, and... said that per section 3A of the agreement, we have decided to terminate PWS Forums and MMAScoops.com from Yard Barker. And knowing that MMAScoops.com and PWSForums.com, which is no longer active anymore, didn't get a lot of traffic.
Yeah, those were your
they were the small websites, and they were, so it wasn't a big hit. It wasn't a big loss. And
bad sign though, because you were even nervous back then.
It was a bad sign
because it means Yardbarker's making changes.
They were making changes back then, and I had emailed
how far
and
these
I,
changes
I
go.
Went back and I read Section 3A of the agreement of Yardbarker, and it says we have the right to terminate websites at any point. So I emailed my rep from Yardbarker, Will, good guy. I mean, I'm not going to say anything bad about him. I emailed Will, and I said, what's the deal, man? And he said, listen, man, we're making some changes to our network, and we're downsizing the size of the network. And I said, well, I do have WZRonline.com and TNAWrestlingNews.com that are still on the network. Are those safe? And I got an email back from him that said those websites were fine, the traffic was fine, everything was good. Due to the fact that a couple of months ago, MMA Scoops and PWS Forums, I would load my email every week, man, and I always thought that it was going to be on a Friday, it's the end of the week, it's as you head towards the weekend, and I had been doing some Google things, you know, searching on Google, a lot of people being kicked off Yardbarker, a lot of downsizing of the network. Last Friday, I got an email, and WZR Online and TNAWrestlingNews.com,
this past Friday,
last two websites that were on the network, got the same email that I had received for MMAScoops.com, PWSForums.com. You know, I was upset, man. And
big
and
deal.
I don't think,
even with your explanation, I don't think they're going to fully grasp.
No, because I'm going to mention something here. And normally I don't talk about this. A lot of people ask me.
It's
you
life-changing.
Know, how do you make money off this, this, that, and the other thing? I will tell you right now that from WZRonline.com and TNAWrestlingNews.com, Yardbarker, every single month, would pay between $2,000 and $2,500 a month. So,
minimum.
When I get... minimum.
Fuck me, man.
So, when I get those emails on Friday...
I've seen some of his checks.
Immediately.
Minimum.
It's a direct deposit in the checks that come in the mail. But you see my stats that are up there. So, basically, I'm always tell you guys like it is. I've lost over $2,000 a month.
Minimum.
$24,000 a year, over $2,000 a month. Fucking kills me, to be honest with you, man.
Yeah.
I'm not...
To interject real quick. Like you said, how do people ask, how do you make money off a website? And you mentioned the UGO and IGN days. Back then, those were amazing companies, UGO, IGN. But even the shittier companies back then were high-paying. And then they call it the internet bubble busted, and the ad game in the internet changed. When the internet first became popular in 99, 2000, 2001... companies were putting millions of dollars into advertising on the internet because all of a sudden there's millions of people on this internet thing, this brand new invention, and this is a new way to expose our business or our company to millions of eyeballs.
Right.
So we're going to inject a ton of fucking dough in here. And then they realized the conversion rate of the eyeballs to people buying the product they're advertising,
people clicking,
and
people
clicking,
signing
up, et cetera,
like
was not worth it. CPM in specific was damn near cut completely out of the equation.
Right.
So to have a company that pays CPM or to have a company that pays well for your traffic is not very rare, but it's a very unique thing. Like you can you can get accepted to a billion companies, but they're not going to pay that well. The ones that pay well are few and far between. Yardbarker was one of the few companies that paid very well.
Talked about CPMs. They were between $80 and $1 CPM for every...
Which is very high these
days. Very, very high.
Yeah.
So they were my main advertising company, and I wound up losing them. I contacted Will. I said, listen, man, what's the deal? Is there any way that I can do a conference call? Can we talk? Can we talk on the telephone? Can I do something different? It was basically the same.
It's like breaking up with a girlfriend. Once you say it and get it done with, you don't want nothing to do with it anymore.
You don't
want to face the music anymore because you feel bad. You know.
Listen, Will and I went back and forth. And
it's not Will's decision. Somebody above him made that decision.
The network, and they are downsizing. And to be honest with you guys, I don't think Yardbarker is going to be around that much longer. As a lot of my advertising reps from 5 years ago, I've been with them for over 5 years. They're not there anymore, and as of within the last year or so, two different ad reps from Yard Barker are now no longer, they're gone.
Yep.
So they're getting rid of staff members, they're getting rid of, their website is
changing
not
their company quite a bit.
Really change, so.
Probably to survive, like you
I
said.
I think, probably to survive and do cutbacks and things like that, and a lot of other wrestling sites have been booted as well, and I know that a couple of them, within the last round of cuts, are now gone as well, so.
So, a big part of it is the conversion, like we spoke about, people clicking ads, doing this and that. So, I know you still got a whole big part of your speech left, but real quick, to fast forward.
I'm
going
to try to make it quick. So
to fast forward, and then you can jump back in the middle here. But the end part, which you might forget to say, a big thing, because a lot of your fans are like, oh man, if there's anything I could do, blah, blah, blah. One thing you guys can do, correct me if I'm wrong, click the shit out of any ads you see from now on.
I'm not supposed
click
to ask you guys to do that, but this guy. Yeah,
you're not.
That's
I
what
am.
I need.
I get nothing out of this. If you, you know, but I'm just saying, if they a lot. I read a lot of your kind. How can I help? What can I do? If there's anything I can do, man, you know, because you got love, bro. I'm there right now. I lost my whole career a couple of years ago, like 6 years ago. You were the only guy there for me.
Right.
You got hundreds, thousands of people. Like, man, if there's anything I can do. It's a small thing to do. You click ads, sign up. If there's something to sign, it helps.
It helps.
It makes a difference. It helps. Because then advertisers know, oh, this site. Because the thing is, wrestling sites, the reason like a company like Arbor would cut the whole wrestling division out is because of the demographic. Wrestling fans tend to be younger. They tend to not give a shit about Pepsi or Coke or credit cards or whatever, the insurance. So they don't click the ads. They read their stories and they go to hell, you know, the porn site jerk off and they go to sleep.
Go
if you click ads, it helps. So that's one thing you guys can
do. It helps big time. So, listen. I'm not going to say, I mean, listen, I went back and forth with Will a couple of times, and listen, they're just downsizing their network. It is what it is, man. So, I lose out on 2,000, 2,500, somewhere
a
in
large
there.
Between, chunk of your product.
Between 2,000 and 3,000 a month is basically what I lose. That's not to say that I don't have other advertising companies that are still running on the websites and whatnot.
Still make a shitload of money.
The deal here is immediately I went out and I contacted numerous advertising companies, sent an email to all of these guys and said, hey, I've got open spots now. I've got a leaderboard, a skyscraper, a box ad, this, that, and the other thing.
The prime spots. Yeah.
I heard back from a couple of them over the weekend because it was weekend. Still waiting to hear back. It's Tuesday right now, but it takes 3 to 5 days to hear back from some of these guys. I've got a conference call with a guy from Beachfront Media. I've got a conference call with PubMatic. I've got conference calls this week with different advertising networks.
Media Strike.
So, Media Strike is as well. Matt Simmons, you are a great dude, man.
Great guy.
These last couple of days, man, I've been hitting you up trying to figure out
cool dude
what we can do, what we can do to make up some of this revenue. And basically where I'm at right now is because I have open spots, out of that 2,000 to 3,000 that I've lost, I figured out a way to make up over a grand of that. So I'm still taking a grand loss, but I've got other advertising companies that I'm talking about, and I feel like I can make that up in the long run. It's just going to take a little bit of time. So
and a lot of work.
And a lot of work, man. But I'll
like
have
I told
to make
him,
that
put
up.
It in simple terms. He's going to have to
last,
work harder to make a little less, probably.
The last thing I want to address is on Friday, I went on Facebook, and I did, you know, listen, I had just got that email. Okay, I had just got that. I'm not gonna lie to you, I was upset, man. Sat in my room for a couple of fucking hours, cried my fucking eyes out, man. Tears flowing out of my eyes,
shit,
man.
I've
came
been
in here to boom. Nope. I said, "What the fuck are we gonna do, man? What's the deal, right? You were cool, man. Everything's gonna be all right." Da 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 da. And I went on Facebook and I put up a post and I said, "My online career is over. Gonna continue."
You overreacted as usual.
I overreacted, man. I said I'm gonna continue to do this part time.
I'm gonna sell burgers at McDonald's.
Gotta go out and look for a real job.
Yeah.
Overreacted a little bit. Was upset at the time. Next thing I know, I got a guy on Facebook. A guy that is I haven't seen. I don't see him commenting on the post. This, that, and the other thing.
Are you not saying his name?
We won't mention it,
okay.
but a guy that I don't see that often,
yeah.
Putting stuff up, and next thing I know, I've got a link to a GoFundMe account on my Facebook. I replied to the thread, I said, please don't do that, man, I don't need that, I would never ask these guys for money, alright? I went to bed, I called it an early night on Friday.
The day it happened, yeah.
The day it happened, I called it an early night. I sent some emails out on Saturday morning. I woke up Saturday morning, and all of my Facebook posts had a link to this GoFundMe
account.
From
the same guy, yeah.
I got emails from people saying that, you know, I donated $50. This thing's up well over $200.
Within hours, it was pretty up there. I was shocked.
A couple hundred dollars within a
couple
of hours. They
love you, man. You guys love this little bitch right here. That's crazy.
So, and
I wish I had love like that, you motherfucker.
I didn't get... There was no email, hey man, can we do anything to help? Can I set up a GoFundMe account? There was nothing, man.
Somebody
so I'm thinking to myself, this is a scam.
Somebody's scamming your fans for money.
I don't think it was. Listen, I'll tell you guys, I don't think it was. I think that it was a guy that truly wanted to do good things, that saw me hurting and thought that I needed money. And, to the guy that did it, I can't thank you enough, man. I can't. That was awesome for you to go and do something like that. Next time, though, man, send me an email.
You
got
to talk to him first.
Send me an email and say, hey, man, can we set up a GoFundMe account? I'll put you on the admin. That way, we make sure that you get the money. And the other thing is, you guys know me, man. I'm on here
every single week. Well, not next time. You would never take money from
me. I'm on here every single week. You guys know that. I've said it before on here. I would never, ever ask money from you guys. Ask for money from you guys. It's not something I would do. I wouldn't do it. And if I did do it, I would be the guy to set up the GoFundMe account. I would be the guy to ask. It would all be official. So, to the guy that went out and do that, his heart was in the right place. He was probably looking to do the right thing.
By the way, I told him to take the money, but you know. He said
no. It was awesome for somebody to go and do that. But I think that the people that did donate, I think people that did donate money, I do think that they got their money back.
I hope
because
so, man.
The campaign
was shut down. I think
the campaign was shut down.
Did you talk to anybody who donated and they said, hey, I got my money back?
They said that they hadn't been charged.
Somebody in here had to have done it, so if you did it and you got your money
but
back,
if anybody, you know, donated money, hopefully you got... I didn't have anything to do with that. And I'm sure, like I said before, man, I'm sure that the guy that did it had a good heart and was trying to do the right thing. Just contact me, man, and we can set something up.
You
can't beg
for someone else because it makes them look bad.
I would never ask money from you guys. I'm okay financially. It wasn't a scam.
He would know.
Right, it was. And a lot of people are saying that it wasn't a scam. So to the guy that did that, listen, I appreciate it, man.
Why did he turn into such an asshole then?
No hard feelings. Well, he came on Facebook.
I should ask you this off the air because I know he turned into a scumbag out of nowhere, but...
I don't know what it was all about.
He was the guy saying you made fun of cancer and this and that, right?
Right, and I don't know where all that stuff... I don't know where all that stuff came from, but the fact of the matter, I didn't have anything to do with that GoFundMe campaign. I'd never ask money from you guys, man. It's not something that I would do, and hopefully anybody that donated, if I ever did, I'd be in charge of the account and everything else. Yeah, so,
and he'd promote the
fuck
out of it.
I found a way to make up over $1,000 of the money that I've lost, man.
I got a raise. That makes up a couple
you
bucks.
You got a raise, man. Yeah. You're living with me. All of our money goes together, man.
We take care of each other, yeah.
It's not about. I'm financially okay, so we're good,
man.
We're gonna be all right. So, and I'm talking with other advertising companies, and we'll get it back on. There's not gonna be an increase in advertisements. There's not gonna be an increase in pop-up ads. We're not gonna.
You're gonna replace one guy's ads with someone else's.
You guys won't even notice, man. If you guys have seen a Coca-Cola
ad, if you didn't say anything, they had no idea.
That may turn to a Pepsi ad. It's not gonna be more pop-ups. It's not going to be more advertisements. Nothing's going to change. If I got to take a $500 hit to a $1,000 hit, so be it. But nothing's going to change, and you guys are going to be good to go. So, now that we got that out of the way.
Out of the way.
Go on. Hopefully, we address. And if you got any questions, man, email.
I guarantee you, at 10 minutes after it happened, he started brainstorming. What am I going to say on the air this week? What am I going
to do? No idea. I didn't have anything planned. I just had said I need to
spend
10
minutes
that,
in the first hour at the top of the show.
But... That's what happened. I lost a major advertising company, and people donated to something that I had nothing to do with. But a guy that clearly had good intentions, I think. But
I gotta apologize on your behalf.
What's that?
You scared the fuck out of thousands of people. I was reading the comments, like, holy shit, WZR's gonna go away. No, you know. Tell me it ain't true. Hopefully,
I did overreact.
You scared people.
I will say that, man.
Apologize for scaring them.
I apologize, man.
Man, you scared the fuck out of people.
I did say I was going to continue to do this thing part time.
You did, but go out. You also said your internet career is over.
I did. You're right.
You contradicted yourself in the same sentence.
You're right.
You said, I'm going to do this part time. My internet career is over. If I'm a fan, I'm like, oh fuck, WZR is gone.
I did overreact. You guys know how to. Listen, you lose $2,000 to $3,000 a month.
Yeah.
Some people don't make that in a year, and that's.
I would say the average American income is probably about 28-30 grand.
Yeah.
And that's only because a lot of rich people make the average higher than it should be.
Even without Yard Barker, we still make. I still make a good 40 grand plus a year. So
I'm fine. Trust me. He still makes more than me. How about that?
Don't need money, and
I wish you wouldn't have said numbers, because now people know I make that little, but whatever.
I'm
after
set.
Fucking 16 years.
I'm,
son of a bitch. Why did you say the number?
I'm set. So no money. I would never ask you guys for money, and it's not something that I would do. You guys know me better.
I used to make a lot more, by the way.
You did, but you got a raise recently.
Recently?
Yeah.
I'm still fucking half of what I used to make in my prime.
Tomorrow's payday for you.
Tomorrow's a good payday, too.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's payday.
All right,
so let me get these plugs out of the way. Let's get into some pro wrestling, man. We've been talking about all this BS.
Yeah, how much time
get it out of the way.
Jesus, we got 10 minutes to fucking break.
I know.
From a Bills and a fucking ad?
Jesus. I know, I'm sorry. That
all right, let's rock and roll.
So anyways, the official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZROnline.com. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/WZR Army. Go to YouTube.com/WZR Archive. We're on Twitter as well. Just go to WZROnline.com, top navigation bar. It's got a drop-down menu. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. WZROnline.com. Get over there. Check it out. Also, our live chat room on and in progress. WZROnline.com/chat. WZROnline.com/chat. Get in there. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. High points and low points of Monday Night Raw last night.
Before we get into that.
We are going to run down the Brock Lesnar thing. We are going to talk Ronda Rousey.
Samoa Joe
leaving TNA, returning to Ring of
Lots
Honor.
Going to
be added to WWE.
Yes.
So we got to talk about that. But let's do the high points.
Before we get into that, I got to explain real quick.
Yes.
Because I know we got a lot of new fans since I've been doing this. The .com. Just to explain it, it started as a way to make fun of this guy right here. When he would do his plugs, he would go WZROnline.com. He would say it like that, and then I would say .com to make fun of him. And then once I said motherfucking.com, and he liked it, so now I have to say that every time.
I liked it?
That's how it started. Yeah.
I didn't like it.
I would say .com, and you say motherfucking.com.
Get out. All right,
motherfucking.com.
Get out of here. So last night I brought, listen, this whole Seth Rollins, John Stewart thing, right? Started out.
Say that name again.
John Stewart, Seth Rollins.
Stewart. We got a local store here called Stewart.
Stewart.
And he says, hey, I'm going to go get some cigarettes at Stewart's real quick.
Am I saying it wrong?
Stewart's?
Stewart.
S-T-E-W-A-R-T equals Stewart.
John Stewart.
S-T-E-W-A-R-T. Stewart.
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 Where's the W in Stewart?
The New York, can I blame it on that?
Blame it on that.
Stewart.
Go ahead.
John Stewart.
And low points, what happened?
So this whole thing started, right? John Stewart winds up leaving The Daily Show, or announces that he's going to be leaving it, right? And Seth Rollins comes out last week on Raw, cuts promo, and says, I'm the man, I can do anything.
Duh. Boone is correct, says DMC.
Who said that? DMC.
Yeah. New guy. I don't know that name that well.
Stewart.
There it is.
Stewart.
You're saying it like
S-T-U-A-R-T. If you say it that way, it's Stewart.
Yeah.
Stewart.
There's another way to spell Stewart. It's S-T-U-A-R-T. That's Stewart.
Stewart.
But Stewart.
Yeah.
Stewart.
Thank God.
Stewart.
Anyway.
Stewart.
So Rollins comes out, cuts promo, and says, hell, I could do, could host The Daily Show and do it better than
you. Know he's leaving The Daily Show, right?
He's leaving
That's how this started.
You know, I just mentioned that a couple seconds
ago. Oh, did you? I'm
but
sorry.
Anyway,
Rollins said it as an offhanded comment a couple weeks ago.
Offhanded joke.
Yeah.
So John Stewart goes on
his show. Big fan of wrestling, by the way.
Huge fan of wrestling. And he was great last night.
He was awesome.
But,
fucking awesome.
So he comes out on his Daily Show.
Daily Show.
And basically says, Seth Rollins, you call me out on Raw, yeah. I'll come, I'll kick your ass.
Splinters, the whole thing, yeah.
He cut a pretty good promo, yeah. And it wound up on a TMZ. So, next thing you know, Jon Stewart's doing his Daily
Rollins
Show.
Did a response promo.
Rollins, it was basically a TMZ thing, and I don't know if they had if WWE had a deal, but Jon Stewart posted a video, winds up on TMZ.com, right? Seth Rollins comes on later in the day, winds up on TMZ Sports.
He tweeted it within seconds, video response within minutes, it was a big business.
So anyways, Jon Stewart's doing his Daily Show this past week.
I thought that was awesome.
Seth Rollins shows up and sneaks up from behind.
And first he appeared on the split screen.
Right.
And then, yeah, while he was talking, Stewart started talking trash like a wrestler again, and out of nowhere.
So
he's right behind me, isn't he?
Yeah, that was cool. That was cool. So Rollins says, why don't you come to Monday Night Raw this Monday, and
Stewart's from New Jersey.
You come into my ring on Monday's Raw. And Stewart didn't say, I'm going to be at Raw on Monday on his show.
WWE didn't confirm to the Washington Post.
They did confirm it.
They confirmed
it yesterday, and then it was put up on .com that Jon Stewart was going to come.
WZRonline.com.
And WZRonline.com. So Jon Stewart's coming to Raw. So Seth Rollins comes out. Opens up Monday Night Raw last night, and it was basically a big plug for
a segment later.
Jon Stewart,
yeah.
I'm going to host the Daily Show.
He's on his way here right now. Blah blah blah.
He had just finished taping his Daily Show, daily recording of the Daily
Comedy
Show,
Central.
And he was on his way to Monday Night Raw right now.
He was already there.
Basically a big plug for that, and then. Later in the show, at about the 9, 10 o'clock hour.
It was in the last hour, yeah.
All right.
It helped the last hour. Normally the last hour, ratings-wise,
was the
lowest of the show.
Mm-hmm.
And actually the first hour was the lowest this week. Second hour was the biggest as usual. Kids go to sleep, but like the diehard fans stayed up.
Right.
Third hour beat the first hour.
All right, no doubt. Which is rare.
So and that was because Stewart's segment was in the third hour.
Rollins is out, and he's got, reminded me of the Jericho, the Jerritron.
Highlight Reel.
5000 or whatever he had out there, right? And he's got a TV screen, big desk. And
you
he's
got the
TV
same desk
screen.
In your room, by the way. This big fucking
is
power
it?
Desk.
Yeah.
It's shaped like an L. Like you can go over here, your computer, over here for your TV, over here for your lunch.
All right.
It's got the greatest desk I've ever seen in my life. This is my desk right here.
But we had, Rollins is out there, and he basically calls out Jon Stewart, right? Jon Stewart winds up coming out, right? The Daily Show's music hits, and Jon Stewart winds up coming out, and they went back and forth on the mic. Listen,
Rollins stayed quiet for most of it.
Jon Stewart last night on the mic.
Yeah.
Wow.
Clearly, he knows his wrestling.
He knows his wrestling, man.
And he's a comic, so he's good at public speaking.
He's a comedian.
Yeah, he's a comic.
Okay.
Comedian.
Yeah.
Comic. Same thing.
It would have rolled off the tongue if you had said, he's a comedian.
Yeah.
But he's a comic.
Halfway through, I said, oh shit, I'm not saying comedian. But comic works just as well.
All right.
He's a comic. He's a comedian.
He's a comic. But anyways,
he's good at public speaking, and he knows wrestling. Those two go hand in hand. He's from New Jersey, so he knew some funny things to say about... I curb stomp people before brunch.
He was talking about Lesnar and Reigns in the WrestleMania.
He went all the way back to Money in the Bank. Kane really won the match for you, not you. Blah blah blah.
He was schooled up on
his
shit.
He wasn't taught.
He's a big wrestler.
He watches like us
every
week.
Every week, and you could tell last night. By the way, and he didn't stutter. There was no.
I put it this way:
everything
week to week. Heyman clearly best promo on the show this week. Heyman's promo was great.
Heyman's pretty fucking good. Heyman's promo was good.
Heyman Stewart, though, it's damn near even.
Yeah, I agree.
And if Heyman's mic hadn't malfunctioned, maybe it'd be, Heyman kills Stewart. But even with Heyman's Heyman malfunction, I thought he made that part of his promo so well that you couldn't even tell if that was scripted.
But wait a minute.
Or organic.
I don't think. All right.
By the way, it was an accident.
When I'm listening to Heyman on the microphone.
Yeah.
It came across clear as day on television. I think it was a problem where Heyman was speaking in the microphone, and it was coming across perfectly fine on TV. But it wasn't going out to the fans in the arena.
The best part
was that what it was?
The big malfunction that, like, it was a couple times, but okay. The fucking dead air was, he said the name, he said something about Ronda Rousey.
Okay.
And then it died, so it was almost like CM Punk. Oh, you got this anti-bullying campaign? Let me
die.
Tell you.
It didn't die on television, though. It died.
No, it was cutting in and out on television.
Was it?
Yeah, I was sitting there writing everything's happening.
Okay.
And as I was writing it, I'm like, yo, Heyman is taking, like, chicken shit and making a chicken salad. Like, he was taking a bad situation and putting it in, like, you couldn't.
That's
I'm telling you right
so
now,
good,
a
man.
Casual fan, 12, 13 years old, like, oh, they did a thing this week where part right. of Heyman's promo was right. there's going to be a fuck-up with the microphone. They would think it was part of the show. That's
right.
how
right.
seamless
right.
the transition was from error to substance.
Hey,
you know?
Let me say this, and I'll get this out of the way real quick. We don't have to
say
run it down, but
mm-hmm.
we'll leave it on this, and then we'll go to a commercial break. We'll come back. We'll finish up Monday Night Raw. We'll take your rapid-fire questions this week. Sunny, I've been trying to get a hold of her all week. And
I told you I jerked off to her.
MIA,
that same
I know,
night, right?
I know. You did.
Last Tuesday night.
Boone said after we went off the air.
I looked her naked shit up and I
Boone
one off.
Jacked off because we had Sunny on the show at the end of last week's show.
She
but
said, I'm sitting here naked and talking to us. Of course, that paints a picture.
Ain't nobody wants to hear about you jacking off.
You're right, because I was talking about the Cooks thing last week and then you
What photos did you find?
Wrestling Vixen.
You were able to jack off to.
Vixen. If you really know how to search for nude or hey, nude shit on
the
internet,
the Vixen you can find stuff, them. Though, she was old and kind of beat up.
No, she wasn't.
No?
She didn't wear a lot of makeup for some reason.
She still looked good on Wrestling Vixens.
Yeah.
Really?
Plus, if you zero in on a body part, it doesn't matter really how good her face looks or anything. That's why when you talk about makeup and shit, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. But yeah.
You mentioned Ronda Rousey.
Yeah.
Paul Heyman's
Heyman
promo.
Mentioned Ronda Rousey.
There was a UFC pay-per-view.
184.
184 this past weekend.
Saturday in L.A., Rousey won 14 seconds.
14
Judo Gene LaBelle says 12.8. He says they got it wrong. Judo Gene LaBelle trained Roddy Piper, Bruce
okay.
Lee, Chuck Norris.
Right.
All right, but yeah, she won 14 seconds. She fought an undefeated number
Kat
one.
Zingano, man.
Kat Zingano, 9-0.
Yeah.
All finishes except for one or two fights was a decision, so she was a killer too.
Right.
Rousey beat her in 14 seconds.
14 seconds.
I've had the hiccup
you know what?
For longer than 14 seconds. She
you know
won
what?
This fight.
Kat Zingano. Came in, and it seemed like she wanted to go right at the Rousey and kind of stun her.
Here's the
kind of stun her.
Yeah, here's
and,
the
and
thing. She is known, some fighters, in boxing and MMA both, are known as, quote-unquote, notoriously slow starters.
Right.
Kat Zingano's theme throughout her career, like, Rousey has a theme. She wins in the first round of every fight, usually by armbar. Mm-hmm. Up until the second Misha Tate fight, every fight, first round, armbar, that's how Rousey won every single fight.
Mm-hmm.
Tate took her in the third round, Rousey armbarred her. Against Sarah McMahon, Rousey hit the knee to the body and it was stopped, TKO. Against Alexis Davis, her last fight was, up until this past weekend, her quickest fight. Judo threw her, punch, stopped it. So TKO
right.
again. So there was two times she didn't win by first round armbar. Kat Zingano's story was, she starts off slow in the first round. A lot of times she would be getting her ass beat in the first round. Within the second or third round, she would turn the tide and stop. Not only win, but either knock the person out, TK Homer Smith. So she had this reputation as a slow starter. So her idea, her game plan, was Rousey thinks I'm a slow starter. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to fucking blitz her as soon as the bell rings. I'm going to charge across the ring, flying knee, bubble, I'm going to fuck her up. And that's what she did. Are you ready? Let's get it on! Kat runs at her, flying knee, Rousey grabs her, throws her, grabs her arm, bam, tap, 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 it's over. That quick.
Even Kat, you know,
she
in
the...
She
is a female Mike Tyson. Ronda Rousey.
Somebody said that.
It's been said for months. Helwani kind of started it.
All right.
But, yeah.
But even Kat, during the post-fight interview, just basically said...
Said the word fuck about 18 times.
You know, like... Fuck!
And you're told not to say cuss words when you're doing on the mic.
It's on pay-per-view, though. It's
even like, on pay-per-view. Lesnar got in trouble for saying, I'm going to hop on my wife and drink Coors Light. Coors Light was bad because it was against the...
That was the sponsorship.
It'd be like you plug in
but
UGO back in the day when you're on IGN. I didn't
right,
want to bring in Gerard
right.
Barker or anything. You know what I mean. Anyways.
But, listen...
Kostak's career is probably over. He got choked out in the second.
Are they going to do a rematch with Rousey and Kat
no.
or
no?
No.
It's either Jessica
I
or Betche Correa. It's hard to say her name. She's
I
Brazilian.
I thought that she already fought Rousey. She didn't.
Jessica Eye?
No, Betch
Correa? No, she, it's spelled Bethy Correa, but it said Betch Correa or something like that.
Okay.
Anyways, she fought
Betch?
Betch.
You ever hear like
B-E-T-H-E
women?
B-E-T-H-E is Betch.
You ever hear like women, they'll be on Facebook and they'll be like, you're such a Betch. You're such a Betch.
I never thought of that. And some people even say Storks instead of Storks. But anyway.
What the fuck?
Betch Correa. Harvey Sarah fucking name.
You Betch.
Stupid Betch. But she had, you know, Ronda Rousey has the four horsewomen.
Yeah.
Here's what Betch did. Betch beat Jessamyn Duke. Then she beat Shayna. After she beats Jessamyn Duke in the post-fight camera.
Shayna Mosler or whatever.
After she beat Jessamyn Duke, she helped, like, the four horsemen would do this.
Right.
So the four horsewomen would do this. Betch beats Jessamyn Duke. She goes like this to the camera.
Did she?
Puts one down. Like, I got one down. After
more,
she beat Shayna Baszler.
More to go,
after
right?
She beat Shayna Baszler, she said.
One down, three more to go.
Two more to go.
And then she beat
Jessamyn
and
Shayna.
All right, there you
so
go.
She hasn't beat the third one. I forget who that is.
Go. All right.
But they're fast-tracking her to Rousey. All right. Now. It looks all like right. it. Or it could be Jessica Eye. Dana said Jessica Eye said she tweeted him after the fight and said, if you don't give me that fight, I'm going to fuck someone
hey,
up.
Hey, I'm a big fan of Holly Holm.
She didn't look that great.
She didn't look that great, but I'm a big fan.
Split decision over a 500 fighter at Raquel Pennington.
It wasn't a great way to make her UFC debut.
No.
But I'm a big fan. I'm a big fan of her, man.
She's a good striker. Legendary in women's
boxing.
Isn't
that what they're trying to build up is Holly Holm versus Ronda Rousey? Isn't that what they're trying to do?
That's why they sign anybody they sign in that. The whole division is built around Rousey.
Yeah.
That's why they won't do Cyborg, because if they bring Cyborg in, Cyborg either has to make 135, which is Rousey's division.
Right.
Or that's it.
Well, if Cyborg,
and Cyborg has never fought
135. Do you think Cyborg is the only chick that has a shot against Rousey?
I think Rousey would gobble Cyborg up for breakfast.
Who said the other day that Rousey could... Joe Rogan came out and said that Rousey could beat up half the men, 50% of the guys
at
in Bantamite. The
135
division.
And Dana keeps joking. He says, I've joked a million times. I don't know what to do with this girl anymore.
Yeah.
We're going to have to start having her fight men. And he says,
right.
I've been joking about it, but to be quite honest with you, short of that, I don't know what the fuck to do with her anymore.
Ian McCall came out today and said, I don't agree with
Uncle Creepy.
Joe Rogan's Uncle Creepy.
Yeah.
He said, I don't agree with Joe Rogan's comments. Rousey couldn't beat a man. He couldn't beat...
No,
I mean,
no, she could beat a man.
Rousey could beat some
man. She could kick our ass.
Kick my ass.
Beat the fuck out of us.
Absolutely.
And she could beat some professional fighters, but...
Right.
Let's be realistic here. There's a certain point, you know.
Right.
She could maybe take out the top 40 to top 30. Once you get into the top 20, top 15, she's going to have a lot of trouble.
All right, so the other... One last thing before we go. We got about a minute to go. John Cena, what do you think about this whole thing with Rusev? We're going to come back. We're going to talk about Randy Orton, Seth Rollins. I mean, clearly, they're going in that direction for WrestleMania. It's going to be Seth Rollins against Randy Orton. They're just kind of playing it week after week after week, and then eventually Orton's going to have enough, and probably next week, I'm guessing.
Gotta be.
3 weeks until WrestleMania.
They clearly... was heading there.
I thought they
night.
Were going to do it last night.
Yeah.
They didn't do it last night, but next week it's probably going to happen. But John Cena and Rusev, basically, John Cena's out there cutting a promo, says, you know, last week Rusev told me no, he's not going to face me at WrestleMania, da-da-da-da-da, so I'm going to enter myself in the Andre the Giant Battle Royal at WrestleMania. Stephanie McMahon comes out.
I'm all grown up now.
Huh?
I'm all grown up.
Damn, damn, I'm listening. So Stephanie comes out and says, since when do guys automatically insert themselves in the Andre the Giant Battle Royal? And John says, well, listen.
Right back to
it. Guys, week after week after week.
That's not exactly murder in a row.
I was talking about the Miz segment last night. Man, a lot of people found that funny on my Facebook page.
I was listening to a radio show this morning.
God.
And he said, it was actually pretty funny.
It was not funny at all.
No, it was not funny.
But anyways, So Stephanie says, you know, since when do you, and Cena says, well, this guy did it. Eventually, Rusev comes out and once again says, no.
Turns him down.
I'm not facing you at WrestleMania. So where do they go from here? I mean, obviously, John Cena's going to wind up facing Rusev at WrestleMania 30. But what are they? How do they set it up? Does John Cena eventually go after Rusev?
He does something where Rusev has no choice.
He has no choice. He has no choice. I mean, something.
If he had,
probably,
if Cena had like a female valet, they could put Lana in trouble, and Rusev, I'll fight you, motherfucker. You know, let her go.
Well, no, but that would be a heel move. You could have John Cena kidnap Lena or something like that. No, you could do
that's
that.
Way too heelish for Cena.
It's way too heelish for Cena, but I mean, listen.
That.
Obviously, it's going to be Seth Rollins and Randy Orton at WrestleMania. Obviously, it's going to be John Cena and Rusev. How they set these up, I mean, Rollins and
maybe he puts him in the STF and he says, either you agree to this match or I fucking choke you, I break your neck right now.
Something like that.
Fine, I'll kick your ass at WrestleMania.
We know how they're going to do the Randy Orton Rusev thing. They're going to do something next week where finally Randy Orton week after week. I mean, like last night on Raw, Randy Orton won Seth Rollins that match with the distraction,
and he
right?
saved him from Stewart.
Yeah. And then after it was over, they beat down Rollins and Randy Orton's nowhere to be found. So next week I'm thinking, you know, Randy Orton says, well, if you wouldn't have won that match if it wasn't for me. And Rollins says, well, where were you after the match? Like, you walked away. You were nowhere to be found. And then it teases tension between the two, and eventually they go at it, and they wound up, you know, they'll do a WrestleMania match, something like that. With Rusev and Cena, it's got to be something like you just said, where Cena puts Rusev in a position where if you don't accept the match with me, or a rematch with me from Fastlane at WrestleMania, this is going to happen. I'm going to do this, or something
this
like
that. This will happen to you.
But we're going to have Cena and Rusev and Randy Orton and Seth Rollins at WrestleMania. So listen, we're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll come back. We'll finish up Monday Night Raw from last night. Rapid fire. Rapid fire.
Coming up.
Tell them how they can submit rapid fire questions.
Simple. I mean, all you got to do is go to www.facebook.com/. What the fuck are you doing?
I'm about to drink a beer, dude.
Ryan Clark WZR. That's facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. Top post. Let's be rapid fire questions and comments. Get on over there. Post them. Keep them brief. For the love of God, we got to read them. So. Facebook.com/
How cool is Jacob? We gotta bring him on here during the post show.
Knowing the wrestling
he
knowledge.
He does the "you can't see me" in the salute and everything
too.
Else.
Yeah.
He's gonna come on here if he's still awake for the post show. But anyways, we're gonna take a quick commercial break. We'll come back on the flip side, taking your rapid fire questions, your live phone calls, finishing up Monday Night Raw from last night. Gonna talk to Samoa Joe returning to Ring of Honor. Also gonna talk to Ring of Honor pay per view. I watched it.
I did
on Sunday night. So we will talk about that and the Brock Lesnar deal with WWE. It's
oh shit!
Be a
Saturday,
lot more serious than what we originally thought.
Lots to talk about there.
Lots to talk about. So you are listening to WZR TV with Matty B, Ryan C. We'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen. Man, this guy, Ric Flair shot. Ric Flair shot.
A hard one.
He can take a beating.
He can take it.
He can take a licking and keep on taking.
Whooping. Jacob,
guy.
I'm telling you, this kid, I have trained him. I'll walk in the door and he'll say, Ryan's home. Ryan's home.
People talking to you. Look, hey, Jacob.
He'll say, Ryan's home. Ryan's home. Want to fight? Want to fight?
No.
He asked me, want to fight? You want to fight?
If we play Cena's theme, will he do it on camera? I don't know.
Watch. Yeah? Oh, yeah. You ready? Show the people.
Listen.
Oh, there it is.
You don't like it on his head. When you say that, then it means he's not supposed to like it.
He was fine at first. Watch. Do it.
What's John Cena do?
We get the salute.
Jake, you gotta go if you're not gonna do it, buddy. We're on camera.
Get out of here.
You wanna do the salute? Do it.
Go get mama. He knows he's not camera.
I don't know. He's all shy.
Are you being shy?
They like you.
The people love you.
Salute. Three fingers.
Nah, he's out.
Alright. Bring him back, man.
Alright.
And we're back. Everybody head to facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. The rapid fire post is up. We want your questions and comments. We're going to get to as many as we can, hopefully all of them here in the second hour. We're also going to take some of your calls. We've got a lot to get to. We've got the Samoa Joe story. We've got the Raw last night.
Yeah, you know
Brock Lesnar thing.
Here's what we're going to do. Because we've already, I mean,
There were three promo segments on Raw last night.
Is she there close enough to get away from
the door? She's going to get him. She's going to grab him. There
relying on her to do it on her
actually,
own.
Actually, there were... it is risky, yeah, but there she is. Okay. There she is. There were four... I mean, the opening segment, Seth Rollins calls out John Stewart. Then we had John... Then we... I'm saying there were four promo segments on Raw last night that we already ran down.
Oh, there was another Stewart one where he was backstage with Renee Young.
The Miz thing. Let's talk about the Miz thing.
Real quick.
All right, Niagara. The Miz comes and it's basically it was him and Damian Sandow who are clearly...
It's loud.
It's very loud.
I'm talking about his crying, which they probably hear, but the sleep is loud. The Miz thing, Niagara.
The Miz thing with Niagara. Listen, clearly they are teasing a Damian Sandow, the Miz split.
Miz
probably going to happen at WrestleMania. Is the Miz?
I think it'll
happen
before Mania, and they have a match in Mania.
At Mania, right.
We've only got three Raws left.
The split is clearly coming where Damian Sandow is eventually going to have enough. He's going to get pissed off. He's going to get fed up. And then
for it last night.
Right.
All right, so here's the quick story. We see Mizdow in front of, I think it's in front of a green screen, shooting a commercial.
See, Niagara is hilarious. All these people, no, I didn't mean to cut you off.
I'm reacting the same way you are, like, oh my god, that's
all these
not
people,
hilarious.
They think it's hilarious, dude.
It's fucking hilarious how stupid it is.
So run it down.
But anyway, I believe he was in front of a green screen, whatever the fuck Mizdow was, shooting a commercial.
On SmackDown, right.
Was it SmackDown? And Miz walked in and was like, no, I'm a better actor. You're not a good actor. I'm a good actor. I should be doing this.
Right.
And he does it. But his lines, taking out of context, he doesn't really know what they mean because, alright, here's your lines, he reads them, and he doesn't put two and two together because the lines by themselves don't mean anything.
Right.
Incorporated into the actual commercial, which we saw on Raw, when we go to a backstage segment, it's Mizdow, the Rosebuds.
They got all the jobbers.
And a bunch of jobbers.
Otis O'Neil, Darren Young.
Was in
there. Darren Young looking.
Darren
quite
Young
different.
Looked like a gangster a little bit.
Yeah. One other thing, and it just crossed my mind because we were talking about jobbers and Megan. Curtis Axel. We need to talk
that
about
that. That was awesome.
Curtis.
I thought it was great.
But go ahead.
So all these people are there, and Miz is like, yeah, here's the world premiere of my new commercial, blah, blah, blah. Miz.
Right.
And Miz Dow's like, Miz, you don't want to do this, man. You don't want to do this.
Right.
They show the commercial. Long story short, it's the waterfall. It's the, have you ever had this problem before? You know, and fucking, long story short.
And the whole punch
it's
line.
For erectile
the
dis-
punch.
It's for erectile dysfunction, which commonly, the most, other than,
commonly known as da, 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 da. At the very end.
What's the other? Not Ambien. What the fuck? There's Viagra is what they spoofed, but there's another one that I was thinking of.
Okay.
Well, what's the other pill? Viagra and something else.
Start with an N.
Maybe. Somebody in the chat help me. Whoever's got a problem with their dick. But all right. So they're making fun of Viagra. It's Niagara, and because they always show a waterfall, which simulates exploding.
Okay.
Ejaculating, if
oh,
you will.
All right,
that's
all
why
right.
they do the waterfall. Okay. Like,
all right,
you know.
All right.
But all right, so they take two and two and put it together, and like, oh, they always have these waterfalls in here. Niagara Falls.
Niagara
is this
Falls.
Big fucking water.
Right.
Viagra and Niagara rhyme.
That's funny. It's a bunch of grown men. Maybe it's not. You and I talked
it's
about
it. It's going to bug me if you guys don't help me with the other pill name.
I don't know what you're talking about, dude.
There's Viagra and there's another one that became almost like more popular.
Then Viagra?
Yeah. My buddy would have what he called a Rattler. He would have Vicodin and Percocets and whatever this other dick pill was called. And he would say, you want one of these, whatever it's called? And I'm like,
Viagra's
no?
For people that can't get up.
Yeah. But there's another one that's just as famous. Cialis. There. Thank you. Thank you, A-Train 001. Thank you, Slayer RRJ.
Cialis? I've never heard of that.
You've never heard of Cialis?
No.
Well,
no. All right. But anyways, so...
Thank you, Robbie, a.k.a. Crazy Roller.
There's a group of grown men, dude, and you and I were talking about it last night, and maybe, you know what? Maybe that same group of young guys backstage...
Steven Gervais says, I have no sense of humor?
They were all telling me that last night.
Because I didn't think Niagara was funny or something else I said. What did I say that he would say that?
Listen, I said to the people last night, all right?
Like the best sense of humor I've ever seen.
No, you don't. You're a dick.
I got
you're
a weird a sense of humor.
But listen, you and I grew up in the Attitude Era, okay? And every week, I did. You were before.
I grew up NWA. Right.
You grew up through the Attitude Era.
I grew up in Hulkamania.
You were a little bit before the Attitude Era, okay? But you grew up you grew up through the Attitude Era, okay? And I started in the Attitude Era, all right? And you grew up before the Attitude Era, like I just said, man. In the
Attitude Era was like 98. I was like 15 or 16.
You were back in the Hulk Hogan.
I was a 10-year fan when the Attitude
you were
Era started.
Absolutely.
All right, so I didn't grow up through it.
You grew up through
I lived
the
through
Attitude.
It, but I didn't grow up through it.
You grew up
I grew up through Hulkamania. I lived through
in
the
Attitude during the Attitude Era, you were what, 10 years
15
old?
15 or 16. Attitude Era was 98, 99.
All right.
I was born in 84.
At 13, 14, 15, 15 it's the
16.
Growing. All right, 15, 16.
I'm a fucking girl. I already 15, dropped 15, out of high school.
15, 16.
I was already smoking crack and shit
15,
with my mom.
16, you're still a kid. You're in high school. You're growing
no, I was
out
of high school. I dropped
you're,
out when I was 16.
You dropped out, but normal kids would still be in high school. They're
normal
growing
kids.
Up.
Yes.
They're growing up.
I was still young.
You were still
I'll
young.
Give you that, yes.
They were you lived through the Attitude Era, man.
I lived through it. Absolutely. Yeah.
You grew
I didn't
up
grow up
through
it. But
sure, you did. But anyway,
I was already grown up.
But the fact of the matter is week after week when you and I would watch the Attitude Era, when Raw ended every week,
it was the cliffhanger.
Wait.
Oh
you
man,
could
I can't.
Not,
I gotta wait 7 days to see what happens.
You could
next.
Not yeah. wait for next Monday's yes. Raw to see what was going to happen, whether it be with Austin, whether it be with Rock.
Yes.
You could Ball not League, wait Triple to League. See what
yeah.
was going to happen.
Her.
All right. And the comedy back then wasn't PG like
no.
Niagara.
Remember the Valvinas?
It was
choppy choppy your penis. Choppy choppy so your penis.
The comedy Giant back time. Then. The yeah. comedy back then was comedy that 30
it was
and
adult
40.
Comedy.
Adult comedy yeah. that 30 and 40 year olds would find pretty fucking funny.
Okay.
When I see something like that on Raw last night,
yes.
and then Raw goes off the air last night, I don't. I'm not. There's no cliffhanger for next week's Raw. What with Randy Orton, but not a cliffhanger like back in the
no,
Attitude Era.
There was nothing like, oh my God, what's going to happen next? Nothing.
And it's like, then I see a segment last night with Niagara.
Oh, wait,
and I'm
in
thinking,
the Attitude Era. Sonny.
But I'm thinking, all right, dude, if you're 10 years old last night and you're watching Niagara, you're thinking, oh, that was pretty funny. They're making
you might not even get the joke.
You may not even get the joke.
You might not even know what a boner
like,
or a
like
erectile or
Niagara,
is.
Right? And I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, man, if I had a regular friend.
You ever had erectile dysfunction?
Just want to shut up and let me talk, man.
You ever had erectile dysfunction?
If I had it. No, I haven't, dude. I'm 34 years old. I shouldn't have a problem getting up, man.
I've been drunk a couple times.
Shouldn't have a problem getting up.
It sucks.
But the fact is,
anyways,
I'm thinking last night is if I'm sitting there, all right, and I'm forced to watch pro wrestling as my job, right? But if I'm sitting there with somebody that doesn't watch pro wrestling,
it's douche.
All right?
Yeah.
It's douche chills central
yes.
last night. Somebody that doesn't watch pro wrestling and they're sitting there next to me last night. They're like, dude, are you watch this shit, dude? Like, are you serious with that? How does anybody find that in the least bit funny? It was the dumbest. it gave me douche chills. I'm sitting there watching it by myself and I'm thinking,
it's sophomore humor to where if you're very young, that kind of stuff is funny. Because it's so, oh, who are you talking about a boner? Like, farts are funny when you're younger. When you get older, they're still funny, by the way. But not as funny. Like, you laugh your ass off when you hear your uncle or aunt fart or something. But when you get older, you're like, hey, fart, whatever. It stinks. Roll the fucking window down. But when you're younger, that kind of stuff's funny. Boners, any sex jokes, any fart jokes, you know, that kind of is funny when you're younger.
Guess,
so if you're younger, I can see why people are like, yo, the Niagara was funny. Plus, like I broke it down, there is a bit of, it's like a not Seinfeld level smart funny, like, oh, that's pretty clever, like clever funny.
Yeah.
But there is a level of cleverness to it because, like I said, Niagara Falls is a waterfall. And they always show waterfalls in the commercials for Viagra and Cialis and stuff. Because of the eruption, the explosion. So, Niagara Falls, Niagara rhymes with Viagra. So there is a level of cleverness to it, and anything about a boner is funny when you're young, so I can see why people would think it's funny. I thought it was fucking stupid, and if anybody that, if we had any friends over last night during that segment, it would have been Douche Chill Central.
It was ridiculous.
But I can get why younger people would think it's funny.
I didn't find
it people who don't
funny.
Really know good comedy.
I didn't find it funny in the least bit. I sat there. You and I were watching it together.
Hey, look, read this comment right here. Robbie, a.k.a. Crazy Roller. Read that comment.
He said boner. All right.
It's funny for young people.
You and I sat there
you
last night.
40 for all
you and I sat there and watched that last night. And when it was over,
it was
you
douchey.
And I said, oh, my God.
Yeah, we were both shaking
what
our heads.
What the fuck are we watching, man?
On Saturday night, when
here's
Rousey
the other
tapped,
thing I want to talk about.
On Saturday night, when Rousey tapped Cat out, here's what we did. We said like this.
Right.
Like we were in shock.
Right.
On Monday night, when that segment was over, we looked at each other and we said like this.
It's
exhale, rolling eyes, shaking hands. That's what it was.
And I don't think a lot of these people, a lot of guys that read my Facebook page and that are on here and that
I read a lot of your comments. You were on point during Monday.
They're probably 12, 13, 14, 15 years old, somewhere around there.
Yeah,
they don't remember a lot of the things from back in the Attitude Era, what happened back in the
Attitude
Era. They
might have heard about them, but they didn't.
And you know how people are always saying, go watch old footage?
Yeah.
People don't do it. A lot of people don't do it. I mean, some people go back and they watch here and there. But if you were to watch every single week back in the Attitude Era, man, it was week after week where you're thinking, I've got to tune in. I can't wait for Raw next Monday.
It was good.
All right, Curtis Axel, man.
Real quick, before
what do you
Curtis
think?
Axel, I gotta bring this up. I'm sorry.
The last thing for Raw, and then we gotta because
I
want to. I
know we're running
time
short
on rapid fire.
I know.
All right,
well, we can go a little bit long.
We can't.
All right, well then you leave and I'll go long and do it in rapid fire.
You're
I got
gonna
no
have
reason.
To do
it. Yeah,
you're gonna have to do that.
Real quick though, I watched the Roddy Piper documentary on the WWE Network today. It's years old, but when this network first started, we knew anything involving Benoit was gonna be edited out. And Owen Hart's death, edited out of Over the Edge.
Mm-hmm.
Those were like the 2 minutes. I'm watching Roddy Piper's documentary today, which I've seen 20 fucking times, so I know every fucking frame of that documentary. They edited it out. He had a feud with Bad News Brown, Bad News Allen from Calgary.
Mm-hmm.
Bad News Brown, Judo
Black
Guy.
Eye.
Yeah, Black
mm-hmm.
Guy. Yeah, all right, I'm fucking impressed. You know who that is.
I know
he's way before the Attitude Era, so. All right, but yeah.
Well, I grew up during the Attitude.
You motherfucker.
You lived through it.
Yeah, all right. If you're a wrestler for more than fucking 14 hours, call a doctor.
It's Niagara.
Call Dr. Death Steve. All right, anyways, they edited the whole part about him and Bad News Brown's feud out of the documentary because what Piper did, it was one of the matches on WrestleMania. He fights Bad News Brown, Bad News Allen. He paints half of his body black.
Did he really?
Half of his body black. He wore the black glove because this was right after the Olympics, where a bunch of those Olympic gold medalists did the what is it called? Black Panther. I'm trying to ignore it, like you should be doing.
Sorry, okay.
Yeah, she's done cooking. Why is that?
You
going
remember
on?
When we had the MMA
Jake
guy,
Shields.
Jake Shields, dude? And you can
I didn't post it because of that fucking reason.
You can't ignore.
What are you doing?
What is going on?
She said fire.
Fire!
Is there a fire? Go check and make sure there's not a fire. She's done cooking, so it shouldn't be going off. Maybe we got a fire on our house right now. I'm actually really distracted because I'm interested to see how this plays out. But anyways, they edited out the whole Piper Bad News Brown thing, which nobody's ever mentioned, so I didn't know that. And the kid's screaming his head off because he's scared of the noise. Was it 18 years after the Olympics, says Dino UK? He would know. I trust his opinion. But, alright. Well, either way, the Olympics was famous, so doing this not only was a Black Panther thing, but it was a sign of rebellion, you know, like... Sorry. His sister said she's sorry. What the fuck was that? Why are you still out there? It's done. He's taking a break in the middle of the show. I don't even want to be here. He's taking a break. Oh. I do want to be here. I love you guys. I love the chance to talk to you guys.
There is a fire, but it's been put out.
Is there?
Flames.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All right, so here's the update on the fire alarm. I'm sure you heard them. There's a fire in our house right now. You can see how worried I am, by the way. Let me see if there's any rapid fire. I'll start answering questions, because he's got a big bucket, so it looks like he's going to dick around for a minute. Hang with me while I hit refresh. If you want to submit rapid fire questions, you can get a couple more in right now. At facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Alright. Holy Christ. People did not listen to the one line request. Oh, cool. The first one's for me. from Mr. Jason Hansen, who's a longtime listener. He says, "Hey Boone, Alistair Overstreet versus Roy Big Country Nelson. Who do you got? Thoughts on the UFC's heavyweight division in general? Who do you think can dethrone Cain Velasquez?" As far as Overstream and, like I said, that was a straight face. Overstream and Roy Nelson, that's a tough one because a lot of people underestimate Roy Nelson, but he does get the job done for the most part. I was shocked to see Mark Hunt knock him out with the walk-away knockout, but he did. I know Andre Arlovski knocked him out in the IFL. Junior Dos Santos knocked out Mark Hunt with a spinning kick. Long story short, Overstream is not looking good these days. I think he's past his prime. He's a blown-up 205er because of steroids. I don't even know if that fight will get to the cage because Overeem's going to have to pass a very, very strict drug test. Or does he? You know what? When is that? He didn't give me the date. I know that... I can't believe we didn't mention this last week. I believe it came out before last week's show. UFC implemented a new drug testing policy. We did bring this up last week, where basically first-time offenders are going to be suspended for either 2 years or 4 years. So Overstream getting to the cage without shit PEDs in his system is going to be a challenge. So let's say everything goes perfect. They get to the cage. Fight happens. I'll go with Overstream.
Overstream and who?
Big Country.
And Big Country. All right. So here's
car on fire?
Here's what happens. I'm going to be honest with you.
Oh, that's not a sock at all. That's something that melted.
With the heating bill here every month,
use the stove for heat. Get to it.
We use the stove for heat. So basically,
not we.
Out in the kitchen, the stove puts out a lot of heat, and it saves us hundreds of dollars, and the stove warms
up. Smart idea if you got heat problems.
It really is. If you guys use electric heat, okay, and you know how it is.
Close enough to your room. Yeah.
You know how it is with electric heat. If you turn up the electric heat, it's crazy.
Expensive.
You get these $400, $500, $600 electric bills per month. So basically, turn the stove on, open it up, saves us hundreds of dollars. Well, when you got a kid... Jacob, he goes out there, and tonight what happened, the reason
alarm
was going off is Jacob decided to put a stuffed animal on the stove.
Oh, dude, it looks like Breaking Bad.
This is
it looks like Breaking Bad. It's a pig with one eye. It's the fucking stuffed animal that they showed in the beginning of season 3 like 20 times.
So Jacob decided to go out there and put
It's dripping on me. What is it?
Jacob decided to go out there and put a stuffed animal.
The fuck is all that?
Oh my god, man. Well, it's water. I had to put the fire
on. Oh, okay.
So
it feels sticky.
When I went out there just now, because the fire alarm and Allison screaming fire, fire, fire.
I heard fire, yeah.
When I went out there, the whole stove, there were flames coming out of the stove.
Really?
And I immediately...
Did it singe the wall or anything?
The wall's black on the...
Is it
the
really?
Side of it was pretty
bad?
Freaking bad.
Here, you do...
So,
I gotta go
Allison had the... She had the sink running. If you look on the stove, there's a lot of burnt pieces. But, so it basically... You know, smoke. The whole house is all smoky now, and there's burnt plastic all over the oven and everything else. But anyways, we filled up a bucket and threw some water on it and extinguished the flames, and we're good to go. Man, anything on live radio, right? Out of any time that this could happen, it happens now. But anyways, what are you gonna do? The fire is out, and everything's good to go. So I don't know where Boone left off, but we need to get to the rapid fire questions. I think we're pretty much finished with Monday Night Raw. Man, I got Jacob out there crying. The whole house is filled with smoke. Flames coming out of the oven. Whew, rough week, man. Rough couple of weeks. Very, very rough couple of weeks around. The car broke down. Cost me $600 to fix the car, right? It's not been a good. Lost the advertising company. It hasn't been good. But anyway, get to our live chat room, WZROnline.com, .com/chat, WZROnline.com/chat. Anthony Remy in the chat room. Everything is okay, brother. Winner's Blair. So what? No one cares. Sorry, man.
Rough Dog, why should I get kicked out? Don't spam, man. Don't spam. The moderators take care of you, man. We're gonna take your live questions out of the chat room tonight as well. So if you guys don't want to call us live, I think I'm gonna have Boone load up the Skype here in a minute. We're gonna have the live phone number to call, and we're gonna be taking your rapid fire questions as well. Just go to facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Taking your rapid fire questions starting right now. We'll wait for Matty Boone to come back. The first one's for Boone. Talks about All-Star Overeem, about Roy Nelson, who you got. I think Boone just answered that when I was coming back, but I'm going to go Overeem, man. I'm a big fan of Overeem. Yeah.
No, it was
Anthony Remy.
Niece, bro. She said there was only three of these left. Her grandfather got four, and it's all fucked up.
Oh, man. All right, Anthony Remy. I am very sick. Why?
Yeah, just the thing shut down.
The computer would have shut off in about 5 minutes.
Oh, sorry. I don't know what's going on. I was telling the people, I said, I think when Boone comes back, I'm going to have him load up Skype, and we're going to be taking live phone calls. We're going to do the rapid fire segment.
Lindsay just came to the door. She's fucking hot, bro.
Oh, she is hot.
Man.
Why does she see the smoke?
God, she said I smelled something or something. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Fucking hot.
So
house, instead of letting her in, she went out and shut the door. God damn it. I'm going to stare at her for a couple seconds.
It's smoky out there.
It's nothing not? Was black. Nothing was burnt. I don't know what the hell you're
no,
talking
on the wall.
About.
On the right side of the wall. Yes,
I looked everywhere in the kitchen. There's no black anything.
Unless she wiped it off. There was soot going
up the wall. There was no black anything.
There was soot going up the wall. It wasn't burnt, but there was soot on the wall. You
there
know
wasn't noticeable anything anywhere. I looked everywhere.
She was wiping it down when
she
I was
said,
out
he must
there.
Have exaggerated for the air. That's what she said.
I don't think so. When I went out there, on
he
the wall.
He must be serious, because normally he'd be smacking me in the leg. Like, dude, shut up. It's part of the show.
When I went out there, you know how if you get a flame and soot starts going up the wall?
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
all yellow and blackish on the wall.
I didn't see it.
Unless she wiped
You're
it down. You
have to show me after we get off here.
Well, if she wiped it down, then it's not going to be there.
Did,
but
yeah.
there was, and see all the plastic all over the
I did
the
see
oven?
That. Yeah.
Tons
yeah,
of
yeah.
plastic on the oven yeah. and then up on
there
the wall.
There was definitely a fire in there. I mean, you can see where you splashed the water because I said, what is that, grease? Is it a grease fire?
I took a bucket.
She said, no, we splashed water to put it out. That's all
I
water.
Took a bucket and I splashed it, and then there was plastic melted all over the stove and up on the wall, dude. There was a yellow and black.
How did that happen? She was done cooking. What?
Jacob went out there and took the stuffed animal and put it on the stove.
Oh,
and
it caught fire.
Because
God.
The stove was on. When I went out there, there were flames coming out of the stove.
Why doesn't she put the baby gate in front of the kitchen so we can't get in there?
Well, that
when
would
the
be,
stove's on.
That would be a good idea.
Be smart.
That would yeah. be a good idea. All right, let's do rapid fire. Load up the live phone calls, too, so that we can take those. Did you already answer the Overeem
one,
and,
yes.
And
yeah.
Roy Nelson?
Yes.
Who'd you pick?
I said, it's a long answer, but to give you the short answer, I picked Overeem.
I picked Overeem, too. I picked Overeem. But if Roy Nelson...
Pick Overeem, I would take your money. I would bet.
Would you?
I would bet
you bet the opposite way?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
See, if Roy Nelson gets on top of you, I feel like you can't get that fat motherfucker off you, dude.
You also can't knock him out standing, really. Unless
yeah.
you're very, very good and very heavy hitter.
Right,
and
right.
Overeem's really a blown-up 205-er, so...
That one was from Jason
The main
Hansen.
Thing was Overeem will never get to the cage. With the new strict drug testing policy they've got,
right.
Overeem used to fight at 205.
Mm-hmm.
Now he barely makes 265. Do you think? Mm. And he was like 35 when he started becoming a heavyweight.
Right.
So it's not like, oh, he hit puberty at 35 years old and finally blew up.
Niagara.
No. Yeah, exactly. He took a whole shitload of Niagara and got fucking huge.
All right, what do we got here, man?
Not this huge, but this huge.
We have about 15 minutes to go. We'll get
Dig.
Through the rapid fire. Take your live phone calls as well. If you guys want to call us live right now, you can do so. It's 518-712-3070, 518-712-3070. Give us a call right now. We're going to be taking your rapid-fire questions.
Hi, am I on
Hello?
The air? Hi.
On the air?
Am I on the air? Is this Ryan and Matt?
Anthony Remy.
I'm a big fan, guys.
I am very sick of the snow. I would love to see
Me
the
too.
Lawn again.
But I was just saying that today. I said, when is this cold bullshit over with?
I love cold, and I love snow, right? I love the cold and I love the snow.
You're
but
a freak
this,
of nature.
This winter,
too yeah, much.
It's a little bit too much,
yeah.
man. I mean, we've had 2 to 3 feet on. I know that there's a phone call.
I'll make sure you get to
I know. I've heard you
can.
Point to it a couple of times.
All right.
They will hold on. But
here's another
but
one. Now we can't get.
They will hold on. I'll call back.
But anyways,
it's very important that we talk about our local weather before we get to you guys.
There's been 2 to 3 feet of snow on the ground for a couple of months, and I'm a little sick of winter. Anyways, caller, thanks for holding. You're live on WZR-TV. What's going on?
What's going on, Ryan? What's going on, Matt?
What's up, buddy?
How you doing, man?
Good, good. Hey, two quick things. Did you guys notice with the John Cena and Stephanie thing last night? She was kind of a little bit of a baby face there, because she said about, oh, Cena, it doesn't matter if you're not in WrestleMania this year because the company doesn't revolve around you. And I think the fans agree with me. And they all started doing yes, yes. And she started doing it with them. And she's like, that's the first time I've ever liked that chant.
Yeah.
And it seemed she's going on as a baby face, and everybody's saying, yes, yes, we don't want to see you. I thought that was rather interesting. I don't know what you guys thought
Let me say this, man. I was watching, I'm going to let Boone answer this, but I was watching Raw with Boone last night, and Boone said to me right then and there, yo, Stephanie McMahon's kind of coming across as a babyface right now, as the fans were already booing John Cena, and then Stephanie McMahon
cut
that promo.
Well, it was a situation where they hate Cena so much that if anybody's trashing him,
right.
Saddam Hussein, if he was still alive, could have been trashing Cena. Get him, Saddam! Yeah! Yes! Yes! Yeah! So it was one of those situations. So, and then, for some weird reason, and this is where I agree with the caller, because normally I would say, no, she wasn't a babyface, it was just Cena was such a heel and that particular crowd. But
keep in mind
Stephanie played into it. Like he said, when they did the yes chant, she said she started doing it too, and she said, this is a rare occasion where I'm happy to hear yes chant. So he's right. She played into it and made herself a babyface.
She did play into it, but keep in mind that they were in Newark, New Jersey last night, and it seems like every time they
anywhere in the Northeast.
Every time they come to the Northeast, the crowd is going to boo John Cena.
Those are the real diehard hip fans.
Right. Anywhere in the Northeast, the crowd is going to boo John Cena out of the building, but we definitely agree with you where you say that Stephanie McMahon was kind of a babyface last night just because the crowd hated John Cena so much in Newark. So, and they're probably going to do the same tonight in Washington, D.C. with the SmackDown debut.
I used to live right near Washington, D.C.
If John is there tonight. So,
caller, anything else before we let you go, buddy?
Yeah, it was great to see AJ back, and then also Bray Wyatt with the casket on fire. When are we actually going to see The Undertaker, like, actually respond to him? Like, is it going to be right at WrestleMania? Because there's 3 weeks left, and the promos are getting a little bit old, unless he's always saying, find me, and then he does the thing with the... I mean, at some point, is he going to, like, you know, come on Raw and, like, respond, or is it going to be all the way up until WrestleMania?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I want to thank you for the call. We need to clear the line to make room for other callers. I'll let you...
As of right now, you know, we put it up on WZRonline.com that, as of right now, The Undertaker is... I mean, like, previous years, they have him appear on Raw week after week leading into WrestleMania. A couple of weeks, you know, 2-3 weeks before WrestleMania, and they have him come on, and they you know, he does his promos and whatnot. But this year, it seems like they're going to wait until WrestleMania 31 and have The Undertaker return at WrestleMania.
I say kind of because, unless you heard different, what I heard was he's not scheduled to be on TV, like you said.
Not scheduled to be
on TV. But he will be accepting Wyatt's challenge in some shape or form. Maybe a pre-tape thing, maybe somebody on his behalf saying he accepts it.
Something like that. So, yeah, I mean, obviously they're going to have to...
Because he's only got 3 Raws left, you either think it's got to be next week or the week after. Because he's got to accept, and then Wyatt's got to change directions with his promos and say, now that we're going to fight, this is what's going to happen.
Now, how does he accept? Something could appear on screen that
it
says, I'll see you at WrestleMania, something like that, where he doesn't
have
to appear.
Or even, like, the Undertaker symbol appears on the fucking WrestleMania logo while Wyatt's looking at it. Like, Wyatt's looking at the logo, and all of a sudden, bam, the lights go out. They come back on, and the Taker logo's on the WrestleMania logo.
Something like that.
I just made that up. That's pretty good.
I like that.
Yeah,
I do
the
like
lights
that.
Go out. He's looking at the Mania logo. The lights come back on. He's looking at the Mania logo. Now the Taker symbol's there.
But basically, some sort of confirmation that
it's
the Undertaker against Bray Wyatt is official for WrestleMania. If I am not mistaken, we have the lovely Jacqueline on the line. Jackie. It was going on.
Hey guys.
Hey!
What's going on?
Hey, you guys! What up?
What's up, Miss
Jackie?
What's on your mind this week?
Nothing much. Okay, here's how I see it. Rusev's gonna give in and say, yes, I'll wrestle you at WrestleMania, Cena. Because somebody tells me that he and Lana are playing something with the Authority. I can tell because I'm like, okay, something's going on with you guys in the Authority. What's going on? That's the million-dollar question everyone wants to know. What's going on with Lana and Rusev in the Authority?
Well, the million-dollar question, what about the million-dollar house that Rusev...
$664,000.
Exactly. I was going to say that it wasn't quite $1 million.
Four-bedroom, four-bathroom.
But what about the... What about
I saw the pictures of the house.
But wait a minute. What do you think about this, Jackie? I mean, you've got Rusev and Lana.
Lana and Edge doing a movie together. Yeah.
They can't stand America. Wait a minute. They can't stand America, right? They despise the United States, but yet...
They're American citizens.
They buy a house in Memphis, TV? Memphis, TV. Or Nashville, Tennessee? What's happening? What's going on here?
I saw pictures of the house. I saw the link posted on it for TMZ, and I wanted to go look at the pictures of the house.
TMZ?
And I'm like, okay.
Why not WZR Online?
I know.
I saw the pictures of the house.
Jackie,
and I'm like,
you just hurt Ryan Clark's feelings. You hurt his feelings. You should be watching this stuff on WCR Online, not TMZ.
She didn't hurt my feelings. We put the article up on WCR Online.com.
Jackie, I'm sorry. We keep interrupting you. What's your point here? I'm sorry. Go ahead.
We linked over to WCR Online. Go ahead.
Is Rusev going to see Cena at Mania?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Well, obviously that's where they're going. I mean, Stephanie flat out said last night, unless Rusev agrees to fight you, you're off WrestleMania this year. And obviously he's not off WrestleMania this year because he's their biggest star. So it's a matter of how do they do the storyline where Rusev accepts. We gave our opinion earlier where Cena puts him in a predicament or a situation where he has no choice but to accept the rematch. So yes, Cena Rusev too at Mania.
I think the more important question is, I mean, we already know, I mean, it's clearly obvious right now based upon WWE storylines that they're going to do Rusev and John Cena.
He's clearly winning the title too, the US title.
The better question is Rusev is undefeated in WWE, and Rusev just defeated.
Look at your hand.
Yes, I know.
We got the same thing.
Yes, but Rusev and John Cena just fought at. Jackie is on the line. We've cut her
off
enough time.
I've never noticed that before.
Yeah, can we
talk
about this later, man? Jackie's on the line.
I don't care enough
about
it. But
Rusev and John Cena, I mean, they recently fought at WWE's Fastlane pay-per-view, and we know that Rusev got the win there. So, does John Cena lose twice in a row to Rusev, and does he stay undefeated?
Or
at WrestleMania, does John Cena kind of get that revenge, win the United States title, and basically that makes everything well. Rusev trashes America, he's got the United States title, John Cena, WWE's United States guy, a guy that's, you know, completely behind the United States, he takes the title there at WrestleMania. I think so. What do you think, Jackie? Does Cena or Rusev win at WrestleMania?
I want Cena, but I'm going to have to go with Rusev. Somebody tells me that he's working with the Authority.
He and Lana are working
with the Authority.
I think the culmination of this whole thing is Rusev's been trashing America. Rusev's already defeated Cena once. He's undefeated. I think at WrestleMania, the biggest stage of them all, what better place to have John Cena, a guy that's all about America, a guy that represents the United States, America.
And Rusev is the U.S. champion, trashing the U.S. Cena's...
What
Cena's
better
first
way?
Title, his main title was the U.S. title.
What better way to have everything culminate than at WrestleMania?
Yeah.
It comes full circle at WrestleMania where John Cena wins the title. He represents America. He represents the United States. He wins the title.
She is making a good point, though. She's saying that she's under the impression that Rusev is privately working with the Authority, which we will figure out at WrestleMania. No, I disagree. I disagree too, but I'm saying it's within reason and it's fathomable that what she's saying is correct. We'll have to wait and see. March 28th or
29th?
29th.
Yeah. Jackie, thanks for the call tonight. It's always good talking to you. 29th. Have a good week.
Yeah.
All right. I'll talk to you guys next week. Okay, all right.
Have
bye.
A good week. All right. Be good. All right. Stephen Grabeck, for Rapid Fire, do you think the crowd at WrestleMania 31 will shit all over the Lesnar-Reigns match?
Yes.
I do too.
Because they know it's Lesnar's last match, they don't want Reigns, they want Bryan, so there's enough elements there, that, and it's a diehard audience, they're going to shit all over.
Absolutely. Brandon.
Brandon Brown says, do you think WWE will actually have Rollins cash in after the main event at WrestleMania, or do they wait because many expect that to happen? I don't see them ending WrestleMania with a Money in the Bank briefcase cash-in.
I don't either,
see it.
But the
next
fact...
Next night on Raw, maybe.
But the fact that the crowd is going to shit all over the Lesnar-Reigns match, what better way than... What better way than to... Alright, if the crowd is going to shit all over it, think about the pop that if Seth Rollins, even though he's a heel, think about the pop that if he comes out to cash in that Money in the Bank briefcase... Where they could kind of save
I don't think
it.
He'll be a heel in that crowd. I think they respect
right.
talent. He's obviously, if not the most talented, maybe Daniel Bryan. He's one of the most talented
but,
guys they've got. They're going to cheer him. And yeah,
me,
like you said, if he cashes in, they're going to explode because they
say,
like him.
Let me say this. There's also 70,000 people, 80,000 people
80,
that are going to be at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
It's not your average Raw crowd.
No,
where
they
you've
come
got
from all over
10,000.
The country.
So.
Or all
you
over the
can't
world,
really
sorry.
Judge the crowd reactions based off WrestleMania. I mean, every year it's 70,000 people. So
are all
70,000? You know what I mean? It's kind of
hard. Are all 70,000 going to want? No, I don't know what you mean.
No, it's kind of hard to base the WrestleMania crowd. I mean, okay,
what's your
point? We're in an arena.
Yeah.
Okay, 10,000 people every week.
Arena, yeah.
This is a stadium at WrestleMania,
yeah.
But every week after week,
okay.
We're in a closed-off
arena, yeah.
All right? And you can really gauge the crowd reactions when you're in a closed-off arena. When you're in a stadium and you've got 70, 80,000 people in there, I don't know, every year
I disagree completely.
Do you?
I say in an arena week to week, do know what you're going to get for the
absolutely,
most part.
I agree.
No, I'm sorry. You don't know what you're going to get every week. Certain cities, I'm sure you have a good idea. Chicago, you're going to get a good... At WrestleMania, you know what you're going to get because you know these are the marks. These are the diehard marks. They're going to boo the shit out of certain things. They're going to cheer the shit out of Daniel Bryan. They're going to boo the shit out of Roman Reigns. They're going to boo the shit out of Batista. They're going to cheer the shit out... You know what I mean? They're going to boo the shit out of Cena.
When I watch
you know that's your diehard fans and you know what they like and don't like. Week to week, you don't know how many kids with parents or girls or... unless you're in a certain city, Chicago,
right.
MSG, you know, I mean, you know what you're going to get in those cities.
All right.
But if you're in Biloxi, Mississippi, you don't know what the fuck they're going to do, you know what I mean?
What we got next? Matt Johnson.
We've got Matt Johnson, even though it's your turn, and I'll read it. He says, 4 weeks ago, you guys were both saying, especially Boone, to sell the WWE stock immediately as it would crash 4 weeks later. It went from $12.50 a share to $7.26. Hashtag don't jump the gun, guys. This kind of leads into my question. Why do people always overreact to everything in the wrestling business? See it every week with Ryan. LOL, thanks. I don't recall ever
bro, if
saying
the
anything
stock,
about the stock,
if the stock, if the stock goes from $12 to $7,
yeah.
Like what you're saying, that's not a good thing. That means the value of WWE stock...
12 to 17.
Oh, to 17. All right. I thought
he says when it was $12.50, we were telling everybody to sell it, mm-hmm. And then it went up. My point is, if I said that, which I don't even fucking remember ever talking about the stock, I'm sure when the network numbers came out at a certain time, we were like, yo, right now is a time to sell it while it's high because we don't know how long it'll take until it raises again.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Then,
of course, let's say 3 years ago we said we should sell the stock. Mm-hmm. Of course, 3 years later, we don't know if it's going to be back up. Who the fuck knows with stocks?
Stock
but at that particular time, if you had just bought stock, sell while it's high. Don't wait to see if it's going to get high again because you're going to be waiting a long
stock
time and you're going to lose all your money.
Up and down, man.
It fluctuates.
It could be $17 today. It could be $14 tomorrow. Now, of course... If WWE reports good fourth quarter earnings, fourth quarter, keep in mind, you've got Christmas, you've got Thanksgiving, you've got people ordering on WWE Shop, you've got people ordering on all this merchandise, you've got people buying Christmas presents. The fourth quarter earnings, of course they're going to go up. The fourth quarter, for me, ad rates-wise, for WWE, it's going to go up. Once you get into the first quarter, it's the worst quarter of the year. Look... I want you to submit that comment, okay? Come April, when we get into April next month, When WWE reports their first quarter earnings, I guarantee you the stock tanks. Why?
You're going to have Mania.
Well, you're going to...
A lot of people are going to buy the network.
You know what? Mania. You're right, because WrestleMania falls in the first quarter this year. Normally it falls in the second quarter.
It's either February or March. It's sometimes April. You're right. It's almost always April. You're right.
So this year, it's going to fall in the first quarter. So you may have a good first quarter.
You're going to have them.
But everything, when they report the earnings, everything is going to be down in the first quarter. Everything is going to drop except for pay-per-view and network buys, which is going to go up.
Yeah.
So it's the first quarter. Everything's going to drop. Okay. Everything's going to drop. Michael Hunter, hey, Ryan, I emailed you 2 months ago. About if you wanted to be a head writer on my wrestling site, I would pay you. My old head writer quit due to family emergency. Michael Hunter, webmaster at ProWrestlingScoops.com, or hit me up on Facebook.
Or email me
when we go off the air tonight.
Yeah,
Facebook or webmaster at ProWrestlingScoops.com.
Ollie Adair says, "Do you think TNA will ever see out the decade? How many years we got in the decade? 5 years." Are they well and truly fucked, or can anything save them? They wasted such a huge opportunity with the reboot.
That. You can just let
you
it go.
You told me not.
You can let it go, though.
Well, if we're not going to answer it, what's the point of letting them sit there and listen to a ring for no reason?
Well, you don't have to. I mean, you stop doing what you're doing, and then you decline it every time.
I feel bad for the guy sitting there listening to it. Oh, it'll be interesting.
Well, it's going
to
ring anywhere. Even if you decline, it's going to ring.
They stop ringing.
It doesn't.
I've called people, and they've hit
me. I've called it all the time, and I hit the... All
right, well, we're taking this call, then. All
right, go ahead. You answer it.
Carla, you're on the air. What's going on? What's on your mind this week?
Good evening, you two. This is Dino from the UK. How you doing?
Hey, Dino! What's up, man? Glad to hear you're good and healthy.
See, it's a good thing we did take this call. Thank God for me.
He said he was going to call an hour, too. That's why I kept pointing to the fucking screen, because it's a foreign number.
I'm glad to hear you're doing better, brother.
I'm all right. Thanks very much. It's from you guys and the guys in the chat room and everybody for doing the great support over the last 5 months. It was amazing. Thank you.
Yeah, no doubt, man, no doubt. I didn't know that until we communicated on Facebook the other day, man. But I'm glad everything's good, man.
Yeah, you're free and clear right now, right? Are you in remission, and what's your status?
At the moment, I've been in remission since the week before Christmas.
Okay.
So I've
good for you.
I had non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. It was in my throat. Oh. There was a lump in my throat, and. We found it early, and had chemotherapy for 4 months, but yeah, it's all good
now.
Hey,
have you ever seen Curb Your Enthusiasm, Dino?
I've not seen what, sorry?
Curb Your Enthusiasm, the Larry David show. Did you ever watch that show?
No, I don't.
Ah, fuck, I had a joke. I was going to say, did you have good Hodgkin's or bad Hodgkin's? Curb fans will understand the joke.
Yeah, there's a guy that wants to say hi to you, too. I met him on Sunday, and he's a fan of your show. X-Pac Sean Waltman said hi to you, too. Saw him wrestle in my local place on Sunday, and he says hi and hopes everything's okay with you too.
No shit, Waltman was in the UK this weekend.
He's a good dude, man. I actually talked to him. I sent him a private message.
Last Tuesday
he was gonna come on here. I actually talked to him on Twitter here and there, so he's a good dude, man. Real good dude.
Yeah, it's we were chatting about my disease actually. It was funny, I've been meeting all these great people and everything over the last few months, and everybody in that chat room has been amazing to me, and it's through you, because if it wasn't for you guys, we wouldn't all be here on a Tuesday night listening, and it's because of you that we all met each other. And I've got the best army in the world at the back of me now.
I say it all the time, Dino UK. I say it all the time, man, on that Facebook page, in the chat room every Tuesday night. These guys are the fucking best, man.
Yes.
They are awesome.
I was going to say is, he says, bro, everybody loves Dino UK. We've known this guy for years. We love Dino UK. We love British Wrestling Radio, BWR for life.
Plug that website, brother. Plug that website before you get out of here, man.
Yeah, it's BSRSports.co.uk. Changed the name last week, so it's changed it now. BSRSports.co.uk.
There you go. Stay healthy, Dean. We love you, man.
All right, be good, bro. Love you, man.
Take care. Thanks very much.
All right, be good, bro.
Good.
Where did we leave it? Dino UK is a great guy, man. He is an awesome guy who supported this show year after year.
We didn't answer
Ellie, Adara, what do you think? Do you think the
team... Well,
you already answered it, though.
Do you think they will make it out of the... Do they last five more years?
I said last night on Facebook, man, TNA has no live events scheduled.
You told me the other day you're afraid they're going out.
They've got no live events scheduled.
Do we know... I'm sorry to interrupt you. Do we know how long their deal with Destination America is?
I think it's a two-year deal. But
Decade is 5 years, so they might not make it.
They've got no live events scheduled, okay? They're doing one night only pay-per-views. They're taping Impact like 10 episodes in Orlando, right? No live events. No, nothing.
They do make money
ratings,
overseas, though.
The ratings on Destination America are tanking week after week after week. This past week,
for that channel,
they were
good ratings.
350,000 people.
But they make money in Europe. They make money, you know, in overseas tours. They make money. So if they switch their business model, eliminated, you know, they've already gotten rid of all of their high-priced contracts. Joe, AJ Styles, Hulk Hogan, Eric Bischoff, dude, you know, you're going down the list.
Bro. I had hopes for them within the past year or two.
Five years is a stretch if they're going to make it that long.
But I don't think they make it two more years.
Well, they're going to make it to the end of the contract, of course.
I don't know that they do.
They're going to tape early, air these shows, and then, the only events they're going to run as far as non-televised goes, probably in England, Europe, you know, the European market.
I don't think they're going to make it 2 years, but...
I'll say they make it 2 years. I'll say they make it a minimum of four.
All right.
Minimum.
All right.
You heard it here first.
All right.
All right. Jordan Paul Paveo says, all right, here we go. What do you think of Curtis Axel's new gimmick? I'll let you go because I know you got a lot to say.
I love it, dude. I got to get out of here, but Curtis Axel, I think in the past couple of weeks has shown a lot of personality.
Yeah.
He's shown a lot of personality, and I thought his promo on Raw last night was pretty fucking good, man.
I think they're positioning him to be the new Santino. Like, he's the comedy character.
Right.
Him and Mizdow, but Mizdow, I think, is about to get a push as a serious character, finally.
Right.
My guess.
Let's see, we've got HB Goo. Is it true that Daniel Bryan has no match at WrestleMania?
He's going to be in the ladder match. Unless they do Daniel Bryan and Sheamus or somebody like that. So we'll see what happens there. We got Mike Jung. Who would win a fight between John Stewart and Austin Aries? John Storton.
He's making fun of how you say Aries. John Stewart. Oh, yeah, and he's making fun of how you say Stewart.
Making fun of me. Yeah. Good one.
I think it was funny, actually. Brandon Brown said, who was it again? I was about to give him props, but he scrolled down. I can't see
it. It's about anything. As good as that Miz backstage segment last night.
Nah, that's better than Niagara, buddy. Brandon Brown says, what did you think of Bray Wyatt's promo last night? Will we see Taker before WrestleMania? Do you think it'll be a casket match? We answered that except the casket match part. They have been using caskets in every Wyatt promo for, like, the last two or three times.
Right.
And he set one on fire last night. So maybe it will be a casket match. And maybe that's how, you know.
Vincent Nugent and Ryan, you noted on your Facebook page a few days ago that your online career was truly over. You certainly scared most WZ Army. Listen, man, I admitted at the beginning of the show, we did a whole thing. Go back and rewatch it. I did overreact a little bit, but we're going to get back on our feet here, man. And I'm taking $2,000 loss here, but we're going to be able to make that up.
Second part of his question is, are you sticking around?
I'll be around.
And Vincent Nugent returns, but he's asking you a question.
Ryan, what do you think about the ROH 13th anniversary show pay-per-view overall this past Sunday night?
Yeah.
You know, I thought it was really good, man, except for the main event. The main event...
Where were they?
They were in... Las Vegas.
Were they in Vegas?
Las Vegas.
Are you sure?
Las Vegas. I'm positive.
Okay.
I'm positive. Okay. But I thought the show was a really good show from top to bottom, except for the main event was a complete clusterfuck,
who was it?
Man.
Briscoe and who?
It was Jay Briscoe and
Jay Lethal fought Del Rio, right?
Yeah, Jay Lethal.
Who was Briscoe fighting?
Oh my God! Why
am I going? You watched it, bro.
I know I did. It was. Oh my God, dude!
Jay Lethal beat Del Rio with the
Ken Ellis and ODB.
Yeah,
on
and
there.
I heard that was good. They did a lot of smoke and mirrors.
There was a lot of stuff on the outside with Michael Bennett
and Mark Briscoe,
who was in the corner.
I'm killing time, so somebody in the chat will help us. But nobody's talking.
It was Jay Briscoe and
not Michael Elgin. No, Elgin's not there. He wasn't even on the show.
Here they come.
It was. Oh my God!
Yes,
help me
help out, us
out
here. Come on.
Oh my God!
Vicious. Vicious in it, and there's the Ustream. Are we cutting out? Whoa. Oh, we're not looking at the chat, so they don't know. I think our fucking stream just died.
It did. I see it up there.
Yeah, it died. Fuck me. That's why they're not answering us. Was it a four-way?
We're out there.
No? There's no video, just audio. Well, then they can hear us. Why aren't you answering our question, you sons of
answer
bitches?
The question! In
yeah.
the chat, it was Jay Briscoe, and it's
right,
up now.
They said we're
everything's
back.
Everything's
yeah.
up
said
now.
We're back.
All right, we're looking. It was Jay Briscoe in the ROH 13th anniversary pay-per-view. It was Jay Briscoe against who in the main event? Help us out. I'm drawing a complete blank here, man.
For the love of God. Guys, refresh your video. It'll work again. Oh, they didn't hear the question. Well, you just asked it again. So now they gotta know. Briscoe fought who at the ROH pay-per-view this past weekend? You're making us look dumb as shit, guys.
I'm sorry. No, it's me making them dumb.
Yeah,
I
didn't watch it.
I watched
it. Yeah, I didn't watch it. Michael Elgin. There you go. All right.
Michael Elgin. That's who it was. All right.
Thank you,
so
Dino
said,
UK. God, Dino UK has come... Oh, and... Tommaso Ciampa and Hansen? Were they in it too?
No,
four-way.
They were in a four-way earlier in the night with AJ Styles.
There's your three opponents, are you sure? For Jay Briscoe. Four-way main event. You watched it! I don't even know what the fuck we're talking about right now. He's going to kill me for making him look dumb at the end of the show, but I didn't watch it.
There was
no idea.
There was so much interference. They had Kerry Silken got involved at one point.
Acer is a trusted guy. He says Hansen, Elgin, and Ciampa.
I do look dumb as
shit. Were the three opponents
forget,
for Briscoe.
I forget. I drank beers on Sunday night too.
I've had vodka and beers tonight. So.
All right, it was a four-way for the main event.
Ranjit.
Ranjit.
Refreshing the video.
What do we got? Oh my God, dude! You still got one.
I got one.
All right, Christopher Brown. Okay, this is supposed to be Sting versus Triple H. Just when they are going to reveal Vince as the one behind Sting coming to WWE, are we walking until WrestleMania for that as well? Are we waiting until WrestleMania for that as well? Or are we going to see Vince? Is Vince going to get involved in the Triple H Sting storyline?
Probably not.
Probably not. Joseph Gallo, so my girlfriend doesn't like going to see wrestling events with me, and I hate going by myself, so I would love to get her pregnant so she is cool with it, and then later in the years I could bring my son or daughter with me to wrestling events. But I am scared knowing if she gets pregnant with my kid is in her stomach, and my kid will come out of her vagina, and I have to stick my dick in there if I wanted to have sex with her after she has the baby. What do I do? So basically,
here's what you do. Here's
dick.
What you do. What do you do? You take a Niagara pill, and you knock that bitch up.
I fucking give up, man. A Niagara pill. That's it right there. What do we got for Anthony Remy?
Your Russian last more than 15 hours, call doctor.
Like I said, Anthony Remy, earlier the ROH pay-per-view was really good, except for the main event, which was they
Are you
going to
tell him about Joe?
Clusterfuck. Samoa Joe returned to Ring of Honor.
At that point.
Got a promo, basically said that I'm glad to be home. It's good to be back in Ring of Honor. I am Samoa Joe. I am pro wrestling.
Today's report.
And I am here. Today's report is...
Okay. I didn't know if you knew. I'm sorry. You didn't allude to it.
But Samoa Joe, it does look like he's going to sign with WWE, which is the reason why Samoa Joe came out, cut that promo right before the main event at the ROH 13th anniversary pay-per-view, said whoever is the winner of the main event tonight, I am going to take out Jay Briscoe, wound up retaining the ROH world title, so it looks like Samoa Joe versus Jay Briscoe. Now, does that happen at the next pay-per-view, or does that happen at the TV tapings coming up this Saturday?
Correct.
Looks like it's going to happen at TV tapings
or a live
this
event.
Saturday, or a live event, more
they got
likely.
A big event. They got a big event during Mania weekend
right,
in
right.
California. So maybe that's their big main event for that show.
More likely it happens at the live event during WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Or, jeez. But it does look like Samoa Joe is going to wind up in WWE. He'll go down to NXT, feud with guys like Kevin Steen, Finn Balor, people like that.
Yeah.
So, last one, man. Vincent Nugent.
Zane, all those guys.
Right,
Vincent
right.
Nugent says, Ryan and Matt, what are your thoughts about the UFC 184 event this past Saturday night, aside from the co-main event and main event fights? You guys touched on the show earlier. Like I said, Koscheck got choked out by Ellenberger. By the way, Ellenberger made more money than Rousey.
Did Didn't UFC release 6 guys today?
8.
8 guys.
Yes.
And the reason I'm going this way is you mentioned earlier that Koscheck may be on his way out.
He didn't get cut.
No. Not cut. But
he's probably gonna retire.
Yeah, you think so?
I would hope so.
And the guys
that's his fourth loss in a row, and before these 4 losses, he had never lost 2 fights in a row.
Okay.
His whole career.
And the guys that were cut today were kind of nobodies.
No. This was
there were two guys.
Akira Korasani, Ryan Bowles, former WBC
champion. That's the guy that I recognize.
Andy Ogle. Ultimate Fighter veteran. Yeah. There was a bunch of guys that you would... Humberto Brown. There were some names on that list.
All right.
Normally when they cut guys, even me, I don't know who the fuck they are.
Right.
I knew 4 or 5 of the names off the top of my head.
Right.
Just looking at the names. Mm-hmm. And then when I looked them up to write the article, I knew everybody. But just off the top of my head, I knew like 4 or 5 of those names.
All right. I only knew Ryan Bowles was the only guy I really
read. Oh my God. Did you hear Burt Watson left the UFC today?
I did. He was the head of media?
He was the backstage guy. Black guy, old guy. He would give you your gloves. He would check your weight before the weigh-ins. He was the guy that would come to your locker room. If you wait in the fight,
right.
You'll know exactly who it is when I say
this.
He would come to your locker room. 5 minutes, baby. You're a fight. You're a knight, get it right. And then when he came to get you, he would say, "We rolling! Right. Yeah, baby! Yeah!" He was, right. He'd get you jacked up.
A lot of guys came out on Twitter today
and
were really sad to see him
After
go, man.
After 14 years with the UFC.
And there are rumors that he got into some sort of altercation with... who was it?
I didn't hear about that.
It was an altercation with somebody backstage.
I didn't really look into the story much. I know he used to work with Joe Frazier in boxing. He's been with UFC for 14 years, which means he was with them right when Zuffa bought the company from SCG.
For a long time, huh?
Zuffa, the new owner, the Dana White Limited.
So forever.
Not forever,
but since UFC really went mainstream.
Since they became back on pay-per-view regulated by the Athletic Commissions. Yeah. He wasn't with the Bob Meyerowitz SCG days, but from Dana White Fertitta days on, he's been their main guy behind the scenes. Dealing with the fighters.
So that's a big loss.
Big loss. Sad loss. Yeah.
Tuesday night, brother. Hey, listen. It's been a rough couple of weeks. And I know that last week we didn't put on the best fucking show.
And this week.
And I know that tonight we didn't put on...
We didn't have a naked Sonny to save us.
We didn't put on the best fucking show tonight. But I think we did better than last week, despite Sonny coming on to kind of save us.
Yeah, that was cool. Last week.
I think we did a little bit better than last week, with the exception of Sonny.
Stort?
But listen, we're going to come back, man. We're trying to get back on our feet. It's been a rough couple of weeks around here. Matty Boone knows. He can vouch for me, man. It's been a rough couple of weeks. So,
and just because I didn't whine about it all night, I'm going through a lot up here too with my sister and stuff. But
with your sister and
you wave it off. I'll punch in the fucking face.
There's just a lot of stuff going on around here. But the fact is, we're still coming on here every Tuesday night. We're trying to give you guys an entertaining show when it's been a really, really rough.
It's hard to pretend like we're not fucked up and hey, knock knock, who's there? It's hard to do
because we walk the air here and
we go back to our miserable lives. Yeah.
Matty Boone and I haven't been in very good moods
of late.
But we come on here for 2 hours.
Give us a week or two, we'll be back to normal.
We'll be back. But we're coming on here every Tuesday night. We're trying to give you guys an entertaining show.
Yes.
And what are you going to do? So Matty Boone,
yes.
Tuesday night, brother. I love you, man.
Love you, too.
We're going to get through this together, man.
You're goddamn right.
With the support of these guys, man. They're all awesome.
Great fans.
Thanks to everybody that showed up tonight. We're going to have live WWE SmackDown main event spoilers up on the website. I got a bunch of news that I got to put up as well. So stay tuned to WZROnline.com for that. We want your feedback.
We want your feedback, and the way you can give us your feedback is by going to Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. That's Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. Let them know what you thought of his performance tonight. If you want to let me know what you thought of my performance, you go to Facebook.com/ Matt Boone WZR.
It's the way they.
We're not looking in a mirror,
if they're watching from there, I think it's.
You're on the right. They see us on. The right.
It's gonna go that way.
I'm watching.
It's a slash. It'd actually be a slash.
Just go to Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. Let us know what you thought. If you like something, let us know. We'll do more of it. If you didn't like something, let us know. We'll do less of it. This is how we give you exactly what the motherfuck you want to hear and listen to. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Blah, 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 blah.
Did you fart?
No.
You didn't fart?
I would probably fart in a mic.
Fart jokes are so funny in 2050. Four! Matt Boone.
Me.
Ryan Clark. Saying see you next Tuesday night. WCRonline.com.
We started from the bottom, and now we're here.
You're not at the bottom right now, but we're going to get here.
Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Is that us? Who do you want?
Dusty Hulk Hogan.
Who?
Dusty Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan?
Yeah.
What about Bray?
Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan?
Yeah.
What about Dean? Dean?
Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan?
Yeah.
Do 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 do.
Where's Hulk Hogan?
I don't know where Hulk Hogan is.
That's you, Bray Wyatt.
Bray Wyatt?
Yeah.
Who else? I don't know where Bray is. Who else?
The Sex came out.
Seth?
Sex came out.
What about Seth?
Sex came out.
You want to help me take the set down? Can we take the set down? I gotta tell you, there are times where there's good shows and there's bad shows, and coming out of this one, I didn't think it was a very good one. I didn't think it was a very good show, man.
Where's Boone?
Boone's taking a potty. Going pee-pee. Going pee-pee. You got chapped lips. You got chapped lips. Let me see.
No.
No? All right. We're going to take the set down. What do you say? You want to take the set down?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Let's take the set down, bud. Alright. You wanna help?
Yeah.
Look out. Get down.